And away we go for today's Sunday fun day shenanigans with Olaf, he of the rag tunic. And oh my god, we need to get this poor boy some pants. Yeah, he absolutely needs to get some pants here, because he is it turns out I am not good enough to run around without armor on. I am relatively skilled at this game, I guess. I mean, for a low skills gamer, I do pretty good for myself, but other than that, he has to upgrade. So what I did normally, what I did before is I said I didn't want to play him off the stream, but I did after the last stream, because I'm like, we're gonna get him some pants, I'm gonna upgrade all his gear. You've seen that happen on the workbench, it's no big deal. And I also took the opportunity to expand his base a little bit. What I did is I got the hoe out, and I got the rocks out, and I started flattening the shit out. Yeah, a couple of lumps here where I could not get it done. I need a pickaxe to get rid of this shit. But he's going to need to expand a little bit, and he's getting to the point where he needs more storage than he has. Yeah, I mean, you look at his chests, and they are just full of all kinds of random shit. And I'm getting overflow on the food, and it's just getting out of hand. So I went ahead and flattened out more area around this, which will be his, you know, main base, I suppose. And what we're going to do is build him some storage, right? Build him a storage rack, get ready for his future expansion of a real workshop and a forge and the various other things he's going to need. What I'm going to do first, though, I think, is move those beehives. We're going to get them off the top of the house and put them over somewhere else where I can get at them better. The bees are happy because these are all empty. Okay, I already emptied them out. All right. First things first, let's go ahead and start building. Yeah, let's start the stream with building. Yeah, I also made him some armor out of the leather we got last week. So I've got a set of leather, and all of his weapons and armor are rank 3. Glantry, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How's it going? So he right now, in terms of gear, is about as close to max Stone Age as we can get. Because I did manage to build the tanning rack, right, which makes his workbench level 3. So all of his weapons and his shield are level 3. His armor is only level 2 because I'm not going to bother with it. His pants are only level 1, only rank 1. So what I'm going to do with it is I'm going to, we're going to go hunting trolls in the Black Forest and get some troll armor here. But first, we need to get the bees done. So let's get the bees done. Dog, what up? How you doing, sir? Long time no see. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Answer for people. Well, Olaf here doesn't have any actual goods down there, so there's nothing really for him to be ashamed of or hide, because he has really nothing. Yeah, I'm gonna knock this down. I'm gonna rebuild the beehive somewhere. Yeah, put him somewhere else. Don't quite know where, but because they have to be unobstructed, right? We know that. They have to be unobstructed. So what I think I'm going to do is just build a little platform back here. Yeah, let's do that. Let's build a little platform back here. And how you been, dog? Last time I heard you had a little bit of a little health issue going on there, and I'm hoping that that's been taken care of. We're just going to build this right here. I don't give a shit. Trapped nerve in your left shoulder. Yikes. Yikes. Well, I hope it doesn't give you too much trouble. We're going to put the ladder. Yeah, I'll put the ladder right here. Fuck it. It'll be fine. Or actually, you know what? Let's try this thing. I mean, this one here is more shallow. But I've got the room over here, so let's try and see what this looks like. And then we're going to turn this one to the inside a little bit. Yeah? Can I snap you here? Can you go there? If I snap you there? What if I snap you here? Will you snap there? Okay, so if I do this, now I get free place. Yeah? So I can just... will it go? So if I do it like that, it won't stick to the wall too much, and I should be able to climb it. Let's try that. Can I climb it? Yeah, I can climb it. There we go. There he is. Okay, let's put our beehives up here. Crafting. We're just going to clump them up right here because I don't care. Put you right here. And here. Put it as close as I can. Oh, God damn it. Well, I hope you get that resolved. Hope it doesn't need surgery. Hope it's something you can just physical therapy. Yeah, that'd be kind of cool. Try and put this up here. It feels like I'm cheating. It's the stranger, dude. Croucha, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. And Aviator Raider, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. And Dalton, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Bees are happy. Bees are happy. The bees need more open space. The bees are happy. This bee doesn't like that. So we have to rebuild that fucker. What are you not liking? Come here. Put you here. Actually, let's line them all up on the house. Yeah. Is that good? Yeah. The bees are happy. Okay. And then let's just line them all up on there. Just to make my life easier. Yeah. Go three here. And then go four. Somebody's grumpy out there. That's okay. I don't give a shit. Put you. Come on. There you go. Right there. Okay. Are they all happy? Everybody's fucking happy. All right. Good. Bees are all happy. And let's see here. So now we're going to do is we're going to give him some storage, right? We're going to make some storage. As a happy bees angry. Well, in this game, the bees are happy means they're not too crowded. Yeah. Means they're not too crowded. They have enough space to fly around, I guess. Okay. So he needs to build storage. Now, in general, as a general rule, if you're new to the game or, you know, you're doing this or whatever the fuck, generally speaking, 24 chests will be enough to store most of your crap and give you plenty of room for the this is meadows. Oh, I haven't even explored the meadows down there yet. Okay. It'll give you plenty of room for exploring and whatnot. So we're going to go ahead and sleep real quick here just to get the sunshine out. But I hope everybody's doing well. The Sardeliac milieu here it's been a strange week. All kinds of stuff happening. Number one, we had a storm last Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and I went to bed and I hear this noise. It sounds like dripping, and I'm like, oh, this is not good. And it turns out my master bedroom had water coming in through the ceiling, which was not optimal. So I went up in the attic and I looked to see if I could see where it was coming from. Did you reset this character? No, I did not. This is still the same guy. The only thing I did from last week, Glantry, is I went ahead and upgraded his shit offline. I upgraded all his weapons and armor, and I gave him some leather armor. And then I, you know, flattened this out, raised the ground, pushed this wall out to have a bigger base. But since you've seen how that works on the stream, and you know that this took me about an hour and a half to get all this done, between chopping all the wood, flattening all the stuff, getting all the rocks and whatever the fuck, to get his stuff going. Now what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to build his thing on the back of the thing here. I'm going to build this chest on the back of the house. So you can see I've got more chests here, and I've got just tons of wood. Just tons of wood. I've just got tons of wood. I just got wood. I'm like, fuck it, I'm just going to get tons of wood. And 451, 351. I'll put this in there. 301. No, I'll just put this thing in there for now then. Okay. So now we're going to build him a rack of fucking... We're going to build him a rack of... Now the problem is this is only 5 wide. So I'm going to have to build 20. To repair your roof. Yeah, I mean, well, I took the bees off and put them on the other side. That's all I've done, really. And I don't remember if I built this portal room last week or not, but I put a portal room on the house. So when we eventually get our shit, we'll be able to put it in there. What I'd like to do is build it over here. Build the storage over here, but that lump in the ground... Oh, my real-life roof. Oh. No, I'm... It was basically one little leak. It only leaked once. And then it rained for 3 more days and never leaked again. So what I did is when it was leaking, I got a meat thermometer. I punched a hole in the fucking ceiling so the water would have a place to get out. So I didn't want it pooling up there. But it hasn't dripped since. It dripped about, I don't know, maybe a half a cup of water the entire time. And never did it again. But I have never had this roof worked on. I've never had it repaired. I've never had it maintained. And I've had the house for over a decade. And we had a hailstorm about 8 years ago. So I could have gotten it replaced back then, and I probably should have, but I did not. Because I was looking at the roof going, well, the roof looks fine. I mean, it doesn't look bad. So I was like, well, I'll just leave it, you know. And if it gets bad, we'll deal with it. Well, it turns out now it's getting bad. Okay, is that going to be enough room to move around or no? Okay, so what I do here is I build my little rack, right? I need it 6 wide. I need it 8 wide. And 3 tall. Right. So we're going to do that. We need 8 wide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we only got 6 wide. 2, 4, 6. 12, 24. No, we need it 3 and... Hang on a second. I'm doing math. I can't figure this out. I need it 3 tall. 8 wide, which is 4 segments. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, right. So it's these 4 here. Started building arcs. We had, down here, it was Sunday night. Sunday night was bad. Sunday night was, yeah, we're going to start building a boat. But Monday and Tuesday, it was just... Monday and Tuesday was just like... sturdy rain. It wasn't monsoon, you know? It wasn't too bad, but it never leaked again. So Tuesday we got an adjuster coming out to look at it. They're all, is the house livable? I'm like, yeah, the house is fine, man. Just I got this water dripping in through my roof, and I know the roof is in bad shape. Okay, I know it's in bad shape because I'll get roofers coming over, and I get, you know, after a good windstorm, I'll find shingles and shit. I'm like, yeah, you know what's up there. Yeah. So we've got that going, and that's fun. So we're gonna see how that goes. My big concern is going to be coordinating getting the solar panels done, because they can't re-roof it with solar panels covering it, right? So, can we use a drone to look at your house? I'm like, sure, you're only going to see about 60% of the roof, because the rest of it's covered with panels, but yeah, go ahead and take a look. I mean, that's fine. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 8, that'll be 24, right? Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and get our wood out here. We're gonna take all that. You're carrying too much, that's fine. I'm just gonna walk right outside and seal patchwork or water gutter. I don't have gutters. Most homes in my area do not have gutters. That's not something that we do. Because we're all sitting on solid slabs, and I need to build a platform so I can do this. I'm not really terribly worried about it. I'm just, my biggest concern is the logistics about getting the panels, of coordinating the guys, you know, to get their shit together, to pull the panels off, do the roof, and then put the panels up without too much interruption in service. What are gutters, exactly? I mean, some of my neighbors do have gutters, and I was thinking about getting them myself, but that's not really a high priority at this point. I mean, I would like to get the gutters done to keep the rain from hammering the crap out of the shrubs. But the shrubs, by now, should be settled in. It's been, what, almost 3 years they've been there. They don't grow for shit. I was really surprised at how little they're growing. And then we had that freeze, of course, which means I lost little bits of branches here and there. And I've got one shrub that's really not really doing its thing very well. So I'm hoping that this will help. Yeah. And we'll see. Like I said, he's coming out on... The thing is, it's not a major deal. I mean, it's a pretty straightforward thing. It just needs to have the roof replaced, you know? I just want to know why the rain only came in on one day. And my friend had a really good theory that I am agreeing with. Is that when it was really windy, what happened was the wind lifted up my shitty shingles. The rain got in underneath into that black stuff underneath, soaked it, and then the wind blew the shingle back down and closed the gap up. because it never leaked since, yeah. And that was kind of telling, yeah. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I just hope it's not too much of a disruption and that we can get it done. Yeah. Winter from 5 a.m. to 7, summer from 12 to 6, fall begins to dark. Yeah. That's only 3 weeks a year, right? The rest of the time it's just heat. Although it is pretty nice today. Pretty nice today. I had a nice surprise when I went to get my tacos today too. So I have two cars, right? I got my SUV, my generic, you know, CUV that I use for daily driver, and then I have a Miata. That's my weekend car. It used to be my main driver, but now it sits in the garage most of the time. And I fired it up a couple months ago, and the air conditioner didn't work. I'm like, okay, the AC went out. Eh, what the hell? The car's 25 years old. I mean, that kind of shit happens. So I took it down to a local shop to get an estimate done, and they're like, oh yeah, we looked at it all. You're gonna need a new radiator and a new compressor and a new this and a new that, and it's gonna cost you like $2,000. And I'm like, yeah, let me get back to you on that. let me go get another estimate somewhere else, maybe. Yeah. And so I was getting ready to take it down to the dealer because the dealer has a coupon, 24% off all service or whatever right now. And I'm like, all right, we'll go check you out. We'll see what's happening there. Went down to Starbucks this morning to get my coffee. And when I was shifting gears, my knuckle accidentally hit the AC button. I turned the AC on and it worked. The AC actually came on. I'm like, I didn't expect this. Yeah, so that's a thing. And so I tested it, right? Turned it back off, turned it back on, turned it back off, turned it back. Sure as fucking hell, the AC works now. I'm not quite sure what the fuck happened there, but I'm not arguing with it because that'll save me a couple of $1,000. If it continues to jank up, then we will work on it. But for now, I am content with the AC working just fine. Very strange. We're gonna put that there. Now we're gonna be sorting. I'm gonna be doing some maintenance here, folks. Okay, so just bear with me here. I have to put my stuff away in the containers where it's supposed to go. Yeah. Okay, that's the trophies. And we take all this out. We take all these out. You are carrying too much. That's fine. So yeah, that was my week. All kinds of weird shit going on. Yeah. All kinds of weird shit going on. And we will see how it goes. Okay, so my pantry is here. We're going to put the boar meat here. We're going to put the deer meat here. We've got leather. This is troll. This will be bone. No. Okay, so we're going to... Okay, so we're going to put the... No. Okay, that's deer. That's boar. And this will be this. That's that. Mushrooms will go here. And then this goes there. Right. Okay. And then in the middle row is going to go resin and gray dwarf. And, okay, that's the meat. Leather goes in there. Yeah, let's put this up here. Put you up there. Put the bones up there. Right. Okay. I have to do this in a way where I remember where everything is. You can label things. There are signs you can make. Yeah. There are signs you can make. But they need coal. And you get coal from doing... I'm going to put you in there. We're going to put you in there. Then we got the wood there. We're going to put the stone here. Leather goes down here. Feathers and flint go here. These are my arrows. The arrows go in this one. Absolutely go in that one. All right. We're getting there, folks. We're getting there. We're doing our goddamn maintenance here. Okay. And then this one's going to have all the treasures, right? Okay. Keep the treasures in there. Then in here, we've got our old gear. And that goes up in the top left. So anyway, that's his storage, right? We're going to make storage. So later on, when I'm actually doing shit, I'll know where everything is. And this empty, 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 right? Okay. Take you out, and we're gonna go bang, 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 bang. Okay. All right. Put the wood away. La-di-da-di. Okay, we've done our fucking maintenance. Holy Jesus. All right, let's get the hell out of here. Let's go kill some shit. I need to make some wood arrows. Okay, so let's make some wood arrows. Let's get the wood out. I'm gonna need that many, I think. Tacos, baby! Let them eat ink. Yeah, no, it's fine. I'm not gonna make them. I'm just saying you can make them without having to, you can make them without having to have a charcoal kiln. You just put the meat on the fire and let it burn, and you get coal, which is fucking cool. Have fun, Dalton. Enjoy your Texas tradition tacos. Okay, so now we got that, and then we need to put the mead in here. Put 18 of those in there. Yeah. All right. Okay. So here we go. All right. Now, where is Eichthir? Have I marked him? I have not even marked him. I never used the thing. So we have to make a field trip to go down there. So what we're going to do... Oh, there's the elder. The elder's over there. Okay, he's across the ocean, I guess. So what are we... You got pizza in the oven? Nice. Is it a cheap-ass frozen pizza? The kind we like here on the channel? Shitty frozen pizza is the best, baby. 10 out of 10 there. Okay, so we got that. We got this. Everything's here. We're set there. We got arrows. All right. Let's get rested and let's get meated. Let's get our groove on. And while we're waiting for this, let's check our skills. Clubs is 19, axes is 20, spears is 16. Okay, so we're gonna have to use the spear. We're gonna have to load this spear up here. No, not that. God damn it. This. And we're gonna do that. Alright, 16 minutes, off we go. Time to adventure. Olaf and his new pants. So now our base looks like this, and you can see how much rock I had to move to get the elevation up here. This little lump, I couldn't do shit. Red Baron? Nice. Cheap pizza for the win. Okay, so we're going to take a field trip down to the other, and we're going to pick up supplies along the way. Yeah. While we get our spear skill up, our run skill up, our jump skill up, and do a little exploring. Exploring is fun. So that's what we got going on in the House of Sire. We got a bad roof. We have a mysteriously self-repairing AC system in the car. And, yeah. Pretty slow week. The kind I like, right? I like them boring. I don't like excitement. Don't give me excitement. Excitement means I gotta think, and I don't wanna think. In other news, in gaming news, I've been playing 76 as I do, you know, doing the... Mole miners apparently have some new plans, so I've been farting around with that. I bought myself one of the rarest items in the game for 50 caps out of a player vendor. If you weren't on the Discord, that actually happened. Garnet has been looking for a responder's fireman helmet for about 3 years. I've never been able to find one. Lo and behold, some guy was selling his fucking machine for 50 caps. I'm like, screenshot? I don't fucking believe this just happened. But it did, and here we are. So, holy fuck. Nice win for me. Yeah, no shit, dude. Garnet is the luckiest fucking character I have, right? She has so far purchased the traveling leather coat for 45 caps. We saw that on one of the first streams we did with her. And then during Fastnacht last year, she bought the Forest Scout mask for 55 caps and a Brotherhood of BOS jumpsuit for 110 from the NPC in Sutton. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? And now she bought the Responder's Fireman helmet for 50 caps. I just... My mind boggles at the odds of this happening. It's like, what the fuck, dude? But yeah, so now all I need for her to complete her quote-unquote set is a regular leather coat and then, of course, Matt gave me the Forest Scout jumpsuit. Traded that for one of I guess it was a QE handmade that I had. And I love that outfit, man. Garnet's been wearing it for a couple of hundred levels now. I don't think I'm ever going to not wear it. It's so fucking cool. It looks so good with the black fixer and the black hat and the sunglasses. And, but yeah, she's still on the hunt for the Red and Forest Asylum outfits. That's where she's lacking. She's got every other color except those two. And then the leather coat. And of course, a tattered field jacket if I can ever find one. But I know Henry's got one of those, so I found one of those already. This is peaceful as fuck. So that's what's been going on in 76. I did try for the 76 people. I did do their exit the vault and go to level 20. Right? And I picked Commando because, of course, Commando is the one I know the best. Because apparently what happens when you do this, right? When you make a new character, exit the vault, and pick level 20, it unlocks 5 new icons, player icons. Which are just, you know, little cartoon images of the Vault Boy in various stages. Like Commando, the Commando icon is basically a cutout from Ground Pounder. You know, there's a shotgun or a melee, you know, like that. And I was looking at the gear they give you and the perks they give you, and I'm like, this is reasonable. I mean, it could be better. They give you like 3 in Ground Pounder. I'm like, yeah, don't do that. Only 2 in Ground Pounder, man. You don't want to do 3 in Ground Pounder. If you want enough to get all the other skills you're going to need. And, oh, look, a house. What's this? And the gun they give you is surprisingly weird. I mean, it's a combat rifle, level 20 combat rifle, which, you know, you would expect. And you want to get salty with me, homie? You don't. Oh, that's right. He has a back brace on. I can't shoot. I can't stab down. But it's modded really well. It's got an aligned barrel. It's got a swifter or quick magazine. It's got a forceful stock, and it's got a reflex sight, which is perfect for VATS people. That's a perfect fucking setup. Doesn't have a muzzle. Yeah, no compensator or muzzle brake or suppressor. But they chose to give it the friggin' automatic 38 receiver. And I'm like, okay, a 38 receiver, dude? It does 27 damage at level 20? That's kind of shitty, dude. You're going to be going through a lot of 38 with that gun. So that was a curious fucking choice, yeah? That was a very peculiar decision to give it the 38 receiver. And the perks are not bad. They're not great, but they're not bad. So it's like, well, I mean, it could be worse. Yeah. I don't think I will do... I don't think when I reroll my lobies, I don't think I will ever use this. Jump to 20. Because its perk selections are strange. Right? There's no gunsmith, for one. But it does give you 3 in commando. And... But it's... It gives you 3 points in traveling pharmacy, and I'm like, man, you need to spread that out a little bit, yeah? But it's, like I said, it's not terrible, but it's not particularly good either. So, when we do our next season, what will be season 17, Scrub? Is it 17 now? 16, 17? I don't know. We're going to come straight out the vault like we do. I'm not going to do, and I'm going to do what I normally do, which is scrap everything it gives you. And but the gear it gives you is decent. True, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. The gear it gives you at level 20 is decent. The perk loadout is decent. Yeah, not particularly good. I mean, you're gonna be spending about 10 levels fixing it, and you're gonna have to really depend on perk drops from the perk packs to get the shit you need. It's not. Honestly, the biggest fail is the fucking 38 receiver on the gun. It's like, it's got to be 45, guys. Just don't. The damage is just too low for level 20, dude. I mean, you could get a level 15 handmade does more damage than that, man. And it's like, shit ain't right. Although they do give you the plan for the combat rifle right out of the box, which is like, interesting. You don't have to go do, the mother load to get the combat rifle plan if you come out at 20, which makes sense because I mean you definitely want the player to be able to craft and scrap weapons to get the stuff they need. I haven't tried any of the other loadouts because I don't know them well enough to know what I'm looking at or whether it's good or not, but I figure if they're as middling as the fucking commando one is, that would be pretty fairly expected. But they give you a set of level 20 leather armor, no combat armor, oddly enough. You would think they would give him combat armor. And plenty of supplies. And you get 6 perk packs plus, you know, 20 or 18 or 19 different, I don't know, whatever perks you get for the thing. odd that it gives you Lone Wanderer too, but it does give you Inspirational too. So I'm not sure what they're going for. It would have been interesting if they'd have focus grouped out with the player base. Like, hey, you've got commandos, we've got a survey here. You know, show us what your build would be if you could just start at level 20 and go from there. And what gun would you want at level 20? You know, not some god roll, but just something that's reasonably decent that'll, something that's reasonably decent that'll get you through to the levels you need to do what you need to do. And it's like, but this is just, it's peculiar. Their choices are peculiar because it's a little bit of everything and it doesn't really focus on, you know, commando doing damage, which is what commandos are supposed to fucking do. Okay, so what are we doing? So there's a mountain right in the middle of the meadows there, huh? There's another segment there, and there's meadows over here that we haven't explored. And we are... Yeah, we need to go south. So let's just go ahead and go south. We got 7 minutes left on our rested, so we're just going to sprint down there, and we're going to figure out where the frick what's-his-name is. Get our run skill up, and hopefully don't piss off any gray dwarves here. How are we doing? 6 minutes? 6 minutes on my buff there? Yeah, that ain't too terrible. Come on, big guy, let's run. So I guess another gaming news, the big gaming news of the week, if you've been paying attention to the outrage merchants that proliferate in this venue, is there's a new game come out that's a early access game preview or whatever the fuck, and it's called Pal World. Yeah. If you've been paying attention to gaming news at all, I'm sure you will have heard of this thing. And, the popular sentiment is, the popular elevator pitch is, it's Pokemon with guns. And so I was like, you know what? I've never really been a big fan of the whole Pokemon thing. Never really played it. Don't really care too much for it or whatever. And I'm like, you know what? It's free on fucking Game Pass. I'll give it a spin. It's only 6 gigs, which tells me it's probably procedurally generated to a certain degree. Uses the Unreal Engine. It's an early access title, so the performance is rough. Doesn't have a performance mode, has an FOV slider, but only goes from about 60 to 90, so you're not going to get a lot of things. There's no way to adjust the camera angle back. And people say, what's it like? I'm like, well, if you took Ark and Valheim and Kenshi and Pokemon and threw them in a fucking blender and threw in some guns, that's pretty much what it is. It's, you build it, but the creature. Yeah, I've been playing it. I mean, I played it for a good. My little character's like on like day 11, and she's like level 15. You know, and it's. I will say, Glantry, that the undertone of the game is kind of makes me kind of uncomfortable. Maybe because I'm an older gamer or whatever, but I mean, in essence, you start the game as a shipwreck on a beach. Your first task is to get some stones and wood, make weapons, and enslave the local population. And you do this by beating them into submission and stuffing them in a box. I'm like, that's a little weird to me. I mean, that's generally the Pokemon thing, right? Is you capture critters and you train them up to fight each other. So that's what happens. You wake up on a beach, right? You're shipwrecked on this island. You wake up on the shore. And if you have a female character, it gives you a gratuitous upskirt shot right from the start. I'm like, okay. But it's a survival game like Valheim, right? Like when the bird drops you off, your first job is to dry off, get some weapons, and start carving your way through. Raymond, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Groucho, you think it sounds gross now? I want you to think about this. Okay. This is made by a Japanese company. When I realized that, I'm like, at least, you know what? At least the pals, the little animals, don't have Korean themed names. So that's kind of good. That's kind of good, right? Right? It's I was just like, what the fuck? Oh, he's over there? Through the peninsula? Oh, that's not bad. Okay. So, yeah, it was, the whole thing was just, are they going for night for more like 1562, dude? I was just like, what in the actual? So, yeah, Extreme Colony. Exactly. Well, that's the thing, right? Because you, like I said, I don't know how Pokemon works, so I've never played it. But to me, when I was going through there, they're like, oh yeah, you can throw those little spear at them and it'll capture them. But it's easier to capture them if you beat them down first. And this is true. It's a game mechanic. You beat them into submission, throw the ball at them, and it captures them. And I'm like, maybe I'm just an old. I mean, there's that too. You know, I'm an old. But I was just like, damn. So anyway, getting past the squeakiness, right? So you get in there and you set up shop, right? You set up shop and you start building your base. The building mechanics are fairly primitive. Yeah. They are not they're not even on a level with this game. But they're straightforward. Basically, you learn. As you level up, you get skill points you can apply. You get points you can apply to your basic abilities. One thing I did like about this is that you can apply it to your carry capacity immediately. Yeah, carry capacity, attack strength, health, stamina, attack strength, and work speed. Work speed is one you're going to want to build, for real. But yeah, so you learn. As you level up, you get what's called technology points, and you buy plans from a very linear top-down tree. Yeah. The tutorial is very, very straightforward. A little rushed, in my opinion, perhaps. It's a little fast, yeah. But it's not terrible. It throws a lot at you at once, which is to be expected. But you get there, you find a nice flat area to build, you build your base. And basically how you build is you pick the thing you want to build, you place down, I guess, a template for it, and then you actually hold a button down to build it. Now, when you do this, if you have little pals in your camp, they will come help you, if they have the appropriate skill. Because they all have an array of different things they can do, right? Some can cut down trees, some can mine, some can harvest, some will work on farms, some can water, some can use flames, whatever the fuck. So you can pick the crew that will automatically do the tasks that they will automatically do the tasks they know how to do, right? And that's kind of cool. That part works really well. They call a sanity, I guess. They have a mood, basically, right? And if they get in a bad mood, they'll stop working. Yeah, or they'll pout, or they'll go to sleep, or whatever. If they're hungry, you gotta feed them, but there's a feeder you can build that will automatically do it for you, which is kind of nice. And, but where the game has a problem, a real problem, which I'm hoping they know about it and fix it before launch, is when you build a bunch of usable things in close proximity, the cursor is all over the place. The selection area is all over the place. It's not under the reticle like you think it would be. It's got some like zone where it can activate things. So if you place, like I did, three workbenches next to each other, you'll have a really difficult time selecting the middle bench to do anything with it. Same thing with chests. I had like four chests in a row. It was a bitch selecting the second chest. I couldn't pick it. It would pick up shit like on the other direction. And fuck you, dude. God damn it. I need heads. I need to kill you. Where are you going, homie? Where did he go? Did he go this way? But it's, God damn, I shot the fucking tree. That's not going to help me. Nah, we're not going to get him. Son of a bitch. Okay, we need to hunt some deer, because I need two heads. Yeah? Stop working. Well, that's the thing. They will do their own things, and you can assign them to tasks by basically picking them up and throwing them at the thing. But for the most part, their AI for task selection is pretty good. I didn't have any problem with them getting to using or performing their given task. Combat is straightforward. It doesn't really give you a lot of stats to work with, so it's difficult to tell what a better weapon is. And of course, like the Pokemon, they've got different types of attacks, and some things are stronger or weaker to things than others, and blah blah blah. And I'm like, whatever, I don't care about all that shit. The taming thing, the pal thing, is pretty involved. It's pretty involved. There's a lot of complexity to it that I, as an old, don't really give too much of a fuck about. it has real problems with targeting. Like, if you're mailing a creature, right, you're facing him, right? If you're mailing a creature, you're facing him. And, it's about there. There's another one behind him, right? Didn't I see another one back there? What happens is, if you're wailing at him to subdue him with, like, an axe or a fucking pickaxe or a bat or whatever, right? And then you go to throw the ball isn't centered. The ball's off to the right. So when you subdue him, kinda, you kinda have to move, you kinda have to move to the right. Oh, I startled the other one. Shit. Oh, it's a pig. Okay, come on, piggy. God damn it, I hear another deer over there. I need to kill these fuckers. There, is he right there? I think he's right there. It looks like he's right there. But it's fun. I mean, it's entertaining. God damn it, the pig took a bullet for the deer. The pig took a bullet for the deer, dude. But yeah, it's just kind of, and it's got this whole Fortnite graphics overlay, which I've never really been a fan of. I mean, the graphics are good, the character customization is good. You can't currently change your character post creation, but shit, we don't have any goddamn. We're gonna need to hunt some deer here. I have to find some deer so I can get some heads so I can summon this son of a bitch and kill him. But it's good. It's solid. It's for an early access title. It's about where it should be. They definitely need to work on optimization, though. The performance is atrocious. I mean, it's the Unreal Engine. It's not really designed for open area stuff like this. It's got good exploration. It's got good... God damn it, dude. I was running away. You little fucker. And, like I said, I played it for about 15 hours, 20 hours. Oh, well, good. We got a house right here. We can colonize. It's a four house. Is it a tall house? No, it's the small, shitty house. God damn it. So now we're hunting for deer because I forgot to bring heads with me because I didn't think it was going to be this close. Okay, I hear you barking, you son of a bitch. Where the fuck are you? Because they refuse to work and change target practice. Well, they get fussy and they stop for a little while, but it's not that big of a deal. What you can do is there's this thing called a PAL box where you can put all your indentured servants go. And if somebody's being bitchy, you just put him in there and take somebody else out at the same time. Put him to work. Where the fuck is that deer? I heard him. Let's get the boat. He's over there somewhere. Let's get our sneak on to get some mushrooms here. But it's cute. I mean, it's the same thing. It's totally ripping Nintendo off. Oh my god. I'm like, no, they're not, dude. If they were ripping Nintendo off, they would already be in court, dude. When it comes to litigation and suing people, there is no company more aggressive than Nintendo, dude. They are up your ass. They are more aggressive than Sony is, dude. They do not fuck around. Where the hell is this deer? Is he behind those fucking trees? Let's run back this way a little bit. See if we can't nab his ass. I need two heads. I'm shocked. Yeah, well, the thing is, okay. This is a valid thing, okay? Because let's face it, if you're a Pokemon fan, I watch some channels where they are Pokemon fans, and Nintendo has been absolutely phoning it in for the last two titles. Just like another game company that we're familiar with, who shall remain nameless, but who recently released a game that, yeah, anyway. So the fact that this game is a better Pokemon game than the Pokemon games, they should be sitting up and paying attention. Am I going to get a fucking deer head here or not? Son of a bitch, dude. Okay, well, I guess we're exploring this island looking for deer today. So yeah, Nintendo should be nervous, yeah? They need to up their fucking game. They need to stop phoning it in, yeah? Because, you know, you put Pokemon title out, it's like printing money. It's like, okay, well, whatever, people will fucking buy it. And, God damn it! You son of a bitch. Ah, I got you anyway. Haha, it took me three arrows, but I did it. Am I gonna get a deer head this time? Deer meat, deer hide, no deer trophy. I don't have any on me. I'm just getting boned here, man. I hear another deer. Well, so you know what? Let's mark this house. just in case I need a house to come back to later. Now, Ike Thier is down here. Yeah, there's this thing right there. And there's our... God damn it, dude. I was not that close and the wind was not blowing that right, you fucker. Have a deer go buy him a meal first. Yeah, right. No, I need to cut his head off and have it as a have it as an offering to the altar over here. Yeah. Hey, bird, I know. What's up, buddy? He's like, hey, you found it. You found a summoning place. They're not easy prey. Yeah. Don't worry. And it tells you what you need to do. It says, hunt his kin. Hunt his kin. I am hunting his kin, dude. No. God damn it. Boar? Point blank, using my thing as a shotgun. Is there a deer over there? There's a deer over there. Right there. I see you. Don't move. Fuck you. I got you, dude. Yeah, he alerted. I got him anyway. Give me a head, bitch. Deer trophy. Okay, so maybe get deer trophies when you're close to the altar. God damn it. Low skills gamer. Oh, and I got him. Third try. Okay, so the third arrow is my magic arrow, I guess. Deer hide, deer meat times two, and no deer trophy. Because I need two trophies to take him out. Okay, so we're gonna be hunting deer here on this tiny little island. Look at this, man. I mean, this is it. This is the whole thing. This is a little stub of meadows here where Ike Thier hangs out. There's a pig. There's a pig right there. Of course I miss. Okay. Get your shit. Now look for some more deer. Hopefully. But look at this island. This is fucking tiny, dude. Okay, there was a deer over here. Damn thing, you turned 50. Well, happy fucking birthday. Welcome to the Half Century Club. Where the aches and pains are all waiting for you here with the rest of us, yeah? Okay, there's that deer. Fucker. Don't you fucking move. See, if they don't move, I can do pretty good at getting them. But if they start moving around, it gets a little dicey, yeah? Did we get a, we got a trophy. All right, good. We got 4 minutes and 28 seconds left. Yeah, we can do him. Fuck it. Let's do this. Let's see if we can murder ourselves a boss here. Yeah. So what you got to do is you got to put it in a slot, which is weird. Yeah. Mystical offer. All right. Let's see if you can do this son of a bitch with a spear. You're still in denial. That's fair, dude. That's fair. Blocked, bitch. Oh yeah, look at this, man. Yeah, whatever, buddy. I'm fed. Oh shit, no I'm not. Let's have a quick snack here. Yeah, see, he's in straight up Stone Age gear. Stab you in the ass. Blocked, baby! Look at that! I'm blocking lightning with my wood shield. That's how uber I am. Whatever, dude. Look at this, man. We're just eating his lunch. This is awesome. Come on, buddy. You wanna come up? Blocked! That's right! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And he's down! Look at that! Did him with a flint spear, baby! Keep stretching before and after bed, yeah. Definitely do that. You definitely want to stay limber. You definitely want to keep your bones going. Alright! He's like, okay, you got his head, dude. Stick it back on the altar. Offers a trophy to make the gods smile on you. Okay, so what you get from him is you get hard antlers, and that allows you to make your first pickaxes. We're gonna try and kill him again. We're gonna see if we can get some more deer meat. So you can get some more deer horns here. See if the game is actually aware of where you're at. It's like, okay, he's near the altar. We will increase the odds that he gets ahead. We'll increase the odds that he gets a deer trophy. Because he's by the deer. We can, you know, do this. Okay, what are we doing here? So you can find some more deer spawning out here. But yeah, you definitely want to stay, so you want to stay active as an older person. You will, you regret it if you do not. But anyway, Power World, kind of fun. I was going to stream it. I was thinking about streaming it today, but I'm like, nah, it's a popular game, and people looking for advice on the new popular game coming here will be disappointed. Yeah. So I was just like, probably better to not. But it's cute. I mean, it's cute and it's easy to pick up, brightly colored. What I do like, and that will probably make the game attractive to Groucho as well, is that when the character creation, right, it's basically male-female, but you can put male heads on female bodies. There's no big deal there. There's a bunch of hairstyles and a bunch of eyes you can pick and whatever the fuck. You can change the color to anything you want to. There's a hue slider and a saturation slider, so you can make any color combinations you want. But for the body, it has three sliders. One for the torso, one for the arms, and one for the legs. Yeah. Which means you can make it skinny as hell at the top and big as hell at the bottom. And I'm like, all right, this is good. Or you can make it, God damn it, dude, where the fuck are you? You're right here, you little shit. Haha, gotcha, motherfucker. Ah, good, we got another trophy. Okay, let's go kill him again. Let's go get some more. Let's go get some more. You get out of my way. Let's go get some more horns. Yeah. Let's go get some more of those. Let me get one more head. So when I get bronze, I can mount it above my fucking door. And actually, how many arrows do I have? 64? Yeah, we'll do them with a bow this time. What the hell, yeah? I always like to get extras because what I like to do is, put a pickaxe in every little outpost. Ooh, that hurt. Okay. I mean, I need to get my bow skill up anyway, so what the hell, right? Got the arrows. Okay. Almost down to half health. La-di-da-di. Find something wet to keep the organ in. Oh, God. I can always count on you, dog. You know, I can always count on you. I know I'm not doing much damage if I did. Marty, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I know I'm not doing as much damage as if I, if I pull the bow back, but I'm not trying to do damage, right? Because with the skills, you get rank ups from how many times you use it, right? So in this case, doing less damage is actually better. So I can shoot more arrows, yeah? I mean, I go through a lot of arrows. Why am I rested? Because we just killed him, Aviator Raider, right? I did him the first time, and we did him with a spear, which is my worst weapon. And I manhandled him so bad that I'm just like, well, fuck it. Let me just kill him again. A sophisticated audience. Nah, man. I don't want sophisticated audience, man. I like the audience I've got. I like crude, crass. I like this. This is good. Because that way I don't have to put on airs or change my thing. XNS90, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Your new player got this Friday Series X server dedicated one, possibly. If anyone, okay, welcome to the stream. Good to see you. Glad to have you aboard. If anyone is on Series X or can, well, it's crossplay, right? Xbox players can play with PC players, right? I thought. Aviary would know that one for sure. But yeah, if anyone's got a dedicated server, you can teach a newbie the ropes. XNS looks like he'd be they'd be ready to hop in and help you farm wood. Make them plant carrots. Put them to work. Indentured servitude. We're taken to the plains. It's crossplay. Yeah, it is. It is a fun game. I like it because it's relaxing. Yeah. There's a deer right there. I'm gonna kill your ass right now. Yeah. See if the deer aren't moving, I can usually get them in one arrow. If they're moving though, it takes me a couple. But seeing them. But see, look how much the deer are spawning on this island. Yeah. Look how much they're spawning next to that altar. It's like the game knows I'm near it, and it's like, okay, we're gonna help you out. And I already got another trophy too. So yeah. Okay. So now it's time to go back home. Now we go hang this up and get the best skill in the game. People say graphics are A. The thing is, okay, I like the graphics XNS because I grew up on Doom and Quake. I'm used to pickles. I'm the original Baldur's Gate, the Gold Box series, Descent, Heretic, Hexen. Dude, I was playing games with pixels from the get-go. And I've always been a gamer who prefers performance over pretty. And this game runs a nice flat 60 all day, every day, forever. I'm like, okay, I can deal with that. But they say, oh, it's not pretty. And you look at this and you're like, I don't know how you can say that. I mean, it's dark now. You can't really see shit. But it's nice. I mean, it was weaned on 8 bits. Exactly. So I love this art style because it is a style, right? They could have totally made the graphics way better than this if they wanted to. They chose this and it works. I mean, I like it. I'm a big fan. I don't have any problem telling what things are, you know? It's not like the graphics are, okay, where the fuck are we going? We're going this way. Oh, look, we're wet and cold, but I don't even give a shit. Dude, I just murdered Aether twice for the fuck of it. Oh, and so, a little thing on Pal World, just so you know. Yeah. What I said is basically Valheim, Ark, Kenshi, and fucking Pokemon thrown in a blender with guns. The first large, in size, Pal that you see is named Aether Deer. I'm like, really? You're going to name it Aether Deer? Really? Second game in general. Yeah, it's Noel. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. How's it going? Yeah, but this game is nice because it's like, it's a full package, right? It's a full survival package. It's, you know, hunting and gathering and upgrading and building and farming and mining and resource gathering of all types, and everything is interlinked. It's just such a well-designed game. I keep coming back to that, guys, and I'm gonna keep saying it. This is a really well-designed game. One of the things that I really like about it, and that in general, as a general rule of thumb, you can tell a game's been balanced better, is that the numbers are low. Yeah, numbers are low. I'm doing good, Noel. Doing good. I got a hole in my roof somewhere, but my AC on my car fixed itself, so I'm going to call it a wash, yeah? I'm going to call it a wash. Let's go ahead and sleep. You're wet. It's raining. All over the place, dude. That's dude. No, even worry about it. We are low maintenance, low key, and juvenile as fuck. So it's just don't sweat it. Don't worry about typos. Don't worry about it. Just like we'll get it. We'll figure it out. Oh, hey, a workbench. Fix all my gear, baby. And okay, so let's go ahead and eat. And now we got 15 minutes on our comfort. Yeah, buddy. Out we go. Okay, so now we're gonna go turn in the head. This is not where one comes when searching for role models. Yeah, well, I mean, we're certainly role models. I wouldn't call it a, you know, necessarily societally acceptable roles, but we're role models. Just depends on what kind of role you're looking for, man. You know what I'm saying? All right, where is it? Here's the hook. Let's put it on the hook. Can I just attach the item? There we go. Activate power. Yeah. It depends on the role. Exactly. Exactly. Circus gotta have clowns, right? Roll for model type. That's right, Hujin. I busted his ass, buddy. You've been granted the power of Eichthir, yeah. Your next target dwells in the Black Forest. The Elder awaits. Yeah, the Elder waits way the fuck over here. Oh, God, dude. Okay, there's got to be an Elder closer than this. So what we're going to do today is we are going to... Okay, you know what? No, we're going to rename this base right here. Let me do this really quick. I'm going to name this one 00. Yeah. Okay. So now we've got... Now we got a choice, right? Now we're going to go to the Black Forest. But what we need to do is go back home. Right? We need to go back home. So we're going to be doing some running today. Thankfully, we have the power of Eichthir. So we can just run probably this entire strip all the way back up. So we need to go sort of northeast-ish. Okay, off we go. No, don't do that, dude. Now, for the next 5 minutes, it costs me 40% less stamina to run and jump. When you need to cover a lot of ground in a hurry, man, 3 stamina foods, power of Eichthir, and you can just go for days. And rested bonus. But now we're just going to haul ass back to our camp, right? To our main base. Because, is this a copper? No, it's not a copper. Because we need to put all this shit away, yeah? We need to put all this shit away, and we need to, shit, we gotta go this way. Well, there's a house here. Did I mark this thing? Did not mark this one. Let's mark this one, too. This is not a really good one, but we'll mark it anyway while we get our stamina back. All right, stamina. Off we go. So our new survival run. Nice. Nice. Have you guys heard anything about the quote-unquote next-gen upgrade they were supposed to put out for Fallout 4? Or has Starfield killed it? Starfield's pretty much killed it, right? I haven't heard any news about it at all. Thankfully, it looks like the devs, Bethesda's learning to keep their mouths shut and their heads down. That's probably for the best. Ooh, mushrooms, look at this. Get some mushrooms while we get our stamina back, and then keep running. There he goes, the power of Eichthir. I can run down deer with this too, which is ironic when you think about it. Yeah, you guys are fine. I've got enough heads. Look out, boys, coming through. We are coming through. Look at the mushrooms in this fucking thing. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go in the Black Forest, and we're going to start looking for burial chambers. Also, we're going to be looking for the merchant, see if we get lucky and we find Haldor fairly close to where we are. Of course, he can't appear closer than, what, 1,500, right? Is that what it is? 1,500 meters, something like that? Out by summer? Well, let's see. We're going to hope. We're going to see what they do and if they actually fix any bugs in it or they just make it prettier. Because based on recent behavior, it looks like making things pretty instead of making them good is their focus. Which, unfortunate, but it, you know, makes pretty screenshots. So what are you going to do? And then hopefully No Man's Sky comes up with a patch at some point pretty soon. Been over five months since their last update, so I don't know what the hell they're doing. Not updating is what they're not doing. Come here, piggy. Yes, I know it was one star. I don't care. I don't farm the pigs. Because I really want to see what they do to it and see if it can catch my attention again with whatever changes they make to it, if they make any changes at all. Because I've been watching, looking at various builds again, and I'm just like, yeah, well, that's the thing. Light no fire? Yeah. A lot of people think it's imminent. It's not. Yeah, absolutely it's not. Okay. Light no fire is at least 2 years away, possibly 3. Okay. What we saw was an in-engine teaser. That was not like a pre-beta sort of thing, okay? Guaranteed. That was to get people talking about it, get it wishlisted, yeah? That's it. They don't have a release date. They don't have coming, whatever. Until they have an actual release date, dude, it's at least years in the future. It is not coming out anytime soon. So, 10 years away coming from them. No, they're pretty good about releasing within a couple of years from the announcement. Put it this way. It would not surprise me to see it at the... It would surprise me to see it at the holidays this year, but I would not be that surprised, yeah? Because they haven't really hired anybody. Their crew size, their studio size is still pretty much the same. And like he said, we have a small team working on this for 5 years. What disturbs me about it is that a lot of it is cribbed straight from No Man's Sky, particularly like the animations. The animations are straight, the walking animations, the fighting animations, they've literally not improved that in any way. And I am very much hoping that, let's mark this one too. I'm very much hoping that they do not treat the player like they do in No Man's Sky. Yeah, I hope they have learned. I hope they hire someone who knows how to do UI. I hope they have hired someone who assumes the players are intelligent and who can handle learning things on their own. I hope. And, but we'll see. We'll see. Like I said, it's going to be years away. Rumors are that at least they upgrade when the TV show comes out. That would make a lot of sense. That would make a lot of sense. That's a really good one, Raymond. When's the show coming out? April? Is that when it's supposed to come out? I thought it was pretty soon, right? No soliciting, Mr. Greydor. Okay, let's get back home. But see, we made it almost all the way back up here by without the thing. So now what we need to do, now comes the first grind, yeah? I was talking about this last week about how we can upgrade really fast. I mean, because this guy, right? In essence, this guy's about 6 hours old, yeah? And I'm a low skills gamer. He has got max level gear, except for, of course, his armor. I just killed the boss twice, yeah? And now it's time to go to the, now it's time to go to the thing. But what you gotta do, see, is go here. Go there. But now we need to get metal, right? Now we're moving into the Bronze Age. You need bronze. Well, how do you make bronze? Tin and copper. Where do you get tin and copper? You get tin and copper from ore, from deposits that you mine with the pickaxe. Ore is very heavy, and in the vanilla game, you cannot take metal, raw metal through portals. I, of course, can because I hate that dynamic because I think it's dumb. So, I can set up a portal and take metal through it instead of having to haul it over ground with a, oh, over land with a cart. But you need a shitload of ore to make your gear. And you need to have a shitload of wood to turn into charcoal to fuel your smelter to make your ore. To make smelters, you need, the Sirtling cores. Turbo Teller, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. All is well. Am I done with Starfield? Oh yeah, I was done with Starfield 2 months ago, dude. I haven't played Starfield since November 12th. And I don't really have any interest in playing it until I see patch notes that at least have a shot of addressing the actual problems of the game rather than making it fucking prettier. Yeah. I mean, it's a Fabergé egg. Yeah. Starfield's a Fabergé egg. It's pretty, it's fragile, it's hollow, and it's largely empty. Cool. Looks good on your shelf, but, you know, whatever. And I don't think... wish game designers go back to making efficient and playable games. They do. They do, Glantry. But they're indie studios that do this. It's becoming more and more rare for larger or mid-range companies to make a polished product. Yeah. Gotta say it, but said it before, I'm gonna say it again. My litmus test is how big is the development studio? If it is less than 100 or over 500, you're in business. If it is between those two, don't do it. Now we put all this stuff away. No blueberries. There's that, and this is seeds. No seeds, okay. So we put in this, no, this, no. Oh, I got some there. Got some piggy meat, got some deer meat. Okay, good. Got some gray dwarf stuff, got the resin. See, this is so nice. This is a quality of life thing that I like a lot. You just go down your row of chests and just start slamming things in containers. Just keep pressing the right stick and you'll just put everything away. So convenient, so convenient. So convenient. Okay, so I've got antler heads, I got trophies. Right, okay. Now we're gonna put away our trophy, right? We're gonna put away the deer trophy, we're gonna put the ice deer trophy, because that's the thing. This is the money bin. Right. No desire to go back. First time ever for this game. Yeah, same thing here, Turbo Teller. I streamed it for, what, a month and a half? Something like that. Put about 600 hours into it. And I've literally done everything the game has to offer. There's nothing in it that is going to be new, interesting, or exciting. And I keep an eye on the Starfield sub, right? Because I want to see if I've missed anything. I want to see if somebody posts a picture of something I haven't seen. And it's been 2 months, dude, and nothing. Yeah, I don't care about building ships. That's something that interests me very much. So it's like, well, what's there? What is there to do? Well, nothing. The same thing over and over. There's no exploration that's worth a piss. You don't get rewarded for it in any way. Where's the bird? I just heard him. Are you in the house, homie? Where'd you go? You outside? Outside. Let's go see what he's up to. What's up, bird? How's it going, buddy? The Black Forest is mission. Did you find copper and tin? Yeah, I know, dude. Now it's time for the grind, baby. You quit No Man's Sky, your base and frigate were broken. Yeah, they broke my freighter. The keel changed, and I'm not really happy about that at all. Okay, so we're going to put these in here. We're gonna take two of them with us, right? Because these things break like nobody's business. I'm gonna need some arrows. Let's grab some arrows. Grab some wood, make some arrows. We're gonna need some more wood arrows. Because what we need to do now is we need to go into Black Forest. We need to find trolls. We need to find trolls. We also need to find burial crypts. We need to find the burial chambers because let's get our bees. So now we come back, we do our harvesting, right? Let's grab our honey. We're gonna need this shit. Because honey and boar meat and this is primitive food, right? We're gonna be getting carrot seeds here, and that means we're gonna need portals. We need portals. We absolutely have to have portals. So we got a lot of shit to do here. Yeah, but first we're gonna take, no, not you, we're gonna take four of you, yeah, and four of you, well, not five, four. Okay, we're gonna do some cooking here, but No Man's Sky, I've been going, well, right now I'm doing a test, because that's what I do. A guy I talked with on the boards, we're curious about whether your bases stay after a permadeath is killed. Do you think BGS should just give Starfield the approach Hello Games took with No Man's Sky and eventually make a good game? Or should they cut their losses and just work on ES6? Okay. A lot of people, Turbo Teller, compare Starfield's launch with CP2077 and No Man's Sky. Okay? I'm going to argue that they're completely different. Okay? No Man's Sky's launch and CP2077's launch were fundamentally good games that were technically bored. Right? Technically broken. They just didn't fucking work, right? 76 is the same way. The underlying design is good, the execution was poor, okay? So all you need to do with that is throw a bunch of coders at it, right? And just hit bugs, hit bugs, hit bugs, hit bugs, hit bugs. It's very much a question of, you know, seek and destroy, right? So it's a very straightforward process. Starfield's the other way around. The execution was good. In fact, it was probably the smoothest launch they've ever fucking had for a game. The design is poor. Okay? It's the choices they made for the game that are poor, not how those choices were executed. Okay? Which means in order to fix what's broken, you need to add a game to it. Yeah? You need to add cohesion between the various subsystems. You need to add consistency in the UI. You need to add variety and interest in the POIs. You need to add compelling stories and good voiceovers. You need to add a reason for NG Plus to exist other than a 1 in 15 chance to maybe get a separate start that's kind of different, but the rest of the game's the same. Okay? So do I think they can pull a No Man's Sky on CP27.7? No, I don't. I don't. I absolutely don't. With one exception. If everyone in their credits that's a lead or a head leaves the company, then they got a chance. But if they don't, they don't. Full stop. So yeah, I'll be watching the patch notes. But they have literally jumped the fucking shark with that game, in my opinion, as a longtime 45 plus years gamer who has seen a lot of shit. The fact that CEO AAA game designers do not care about their customer base. Oh no, they are comfortable with their customer base. Okay. But what their customer base wants and what their customer base is willing to put up with are two different things. And the CEOs are banking on what they'll put up with. Until people stop fucking pre-ordering, until they stop buying day one, until they stop putting up with broken, buggy, fucking flawed products, until they stop buying things MTX style, there's literally no reason for them to change a thing, dude. Because the CEO's looking at the money. Troll. Okay, here we fucking go. Are we going to be able to do him? Let's do him with our spear, boys. I hear you, you son of a bitch. Where are you? Come on. Let's fuck you up, dude. I heard you. Where are you at? You're not over there. There you are. I see you. Okay, can we do a troll? Flint spear? We're going to do it? We're feeling ballsy coming off of Ike there, right? Wood arrows, baby. Come on, big boy. Oh, yeah. Here he comes. Can we do him? We're going to fucking find out. All right, switch to the spear. Yeah, whatever, Bubba. Come on. Come on down here. Ooh, put the shield on. Yeah, bitch. How you like that? Oh, shit. Yeah, no. Where's my spear? Where did my spear go? Is he sitting on it? Come on, man. Get off my spear. Come on. Come on. Where's my spear? Is it here? Why can't I pick up? Oh, because I turned off auto pickup. Oh, God, I'm an idiot. Oh, fuck. Come on, buddy. All right. I got my spear now. Yeah, how you like that? Right in the dick. Yeah, that's how we do it. Motherfucker. Give me that skin, bitch. That's what's up. Fuck you, buddy. I got your number. Okay, so we can take him with a flint spear. Nice. Now we got to kill about 30 more of them. La-dee-dee. Oh, look at this. A copper deposit right here. Oh, isn't this tasty? Right next to my camp. Okay. I don't know how interested you will be to watch a copper farming stream. Okay. But I will tell you right now, that copper deposit I just marked will take this character, in all likelihood, the better part of a week, a game week, which is 3.5 hours to clear. Because we're looking at this thing, right? We're looking at this copper deposit, and you're like, man, this is a big chunk of copper. Dude, we're only looking at like 10% of it. The rest of it's all underground. There's just tons of it there. Okay, so what are we going to do? Let's go explore the Black Forest, where we killed a fucking troll with a flint spear. Just tanked his ass the fuck down. Now, full disclosure, I am playing on very easy. However, I'm a low skills gamer. So if you're playing on normal and you have, you know, normal reflexes and good eyesight and you know, good hand-eye coordination, you'll be able to do what I just did on normal. And if you're really good, you'll be able to do it on very hard. But, okay, so we're looking for skeletons now. Yeah? We're looking for skeletons. We're looking for burial chambers. Because I need to make portals. We need to kill some gray dwarfs. I need to make portals. Because I got to connect all my bases. Oh, a boar. Oh, piggy. Come here, piggies. Come here, buddy. Where the fuck are you going, dude? Come on. There we go. All right, now our first gray dwarfs. Come on, man. You want it? Come on. Yeah, bitch. Got plenty for everybody, boys. Come on. I just took down a troll. I ain't worried about your dumbass. Come on. Yeah, you try and heal him, Mr. Shaman. Oh, I got your number, buddy. Come on. Let's do it. Yeah, bitch. Okay, so there's my eyes. There's my resin. Fuck yeah. Get my shit. Get all my loots. Oh, yeah. Get my mushroom. All right. Active opinion, leadership management, a little poor direction. The thing is, they have good direction. They're good at their jobs, okay? But their job does not count on the product being good. It counts on the product selling. This is a different, entirely different way of looking at the entertainment industry, yeah? It doesn't have to be good. It just has to sell, yeah? So it just has to be good enough. Where you get the gamer rage is when you see a company going backwards in quality, yeah? And you're like, okay, you guys are going the wrong fucking direction. Okay, here is a tin deposit, right? So we're going to farm this fucker, right? We're going to need lots of tin. So we're going to just hammer this fucker, right? Now, this makes a lot of noise, so things are going to come running to check this out. A leech? Here? What? Oh, there's swamp right there. Oh, this is not good. This is not good. Mind Mental X, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. New at the game. Yeah, welcome to the stream. Is it Mind Mental? Yeah, I know I need a smelter. Fucking swamp right here? Okay, let's see if we can take this asshole out. We probably can't. If we shoot him a couple times, he's gonna swim away. Yeah. I don't care. He'll come back, though. If I sit in the water, he'll come back. Do not fuck with leeches unless you have poison protection, dude. They will body you so hard. So hard. Dude. You will be so fucking dead so fast without poison protection. Sorry to shout. Yeah, okay. So, can I give you some advice? My mental X. Okay. The one skill you want to work on and the one piece of equipment you want to have. You see this shield right here? You look down at the bottom of its stats in the box. It says parry bonus. Okay. You want to use a shield that has parry bonus. Okay. And you want to work on parrying. Okay. Parrying, what parrying does, if you time an enemy's attack correctly and you put the shield up right in time, it will parry. What parry does is it automatically staggers them, and it gives you a bonus. There he is. Yeah. Come back, bitch. I see you, honey. Come on. Fuck you, dude. Blood bag. Yay, now I can make frost potions. But once you have mastered the parry, yeah, and you get the timing down, because every enemy's got a different attack speed, right? Different kind of attack, they telegraph it differently, make different sounds, different animations, whatever the fuck. With the trolls, you want to parry right before they hit you. Resist the temptation to put the shield up when they are swinging. It's right before they make contact, you put it up, and it staggers them, okay? Trolls are weak to pierce. Pierce in this case being bows, being arrows, and the spear, right? So you stagger them, lean in, whack them in the nuts a couple times, then wait, right? Because you're not going to do enough damage to stagger them again at this early stage, right? When you get higher, right? My other characters have like ancient bark spears. If I stagger a troll, I can stun lock him, dude. He's just done. I can do so much damage so fucking fast that he'll never recover. But with this guy, a minimum block parry skill. No, you don't need a minimum block at all. You just need to be able to block consistently every time. You also need to be well fed. There, see what I mean? Look, see him got staggered? Watch. We'll do this here. Well, if he was... For him, it's halfway through his windup. Right there. But see how he staggers? It makes that ringing noise? Practice on these guys. Practice on skeletons. Yeah? Just stand here. Yeah? Now, the thing to remember is when you're blocking, right? You see to the right, there's that little meter that keeps popping up and going away? What that meter is your stagger meter. If you take enough damage that stagger meter is based on your total health. The higher your health, the harder you are to stagger, because the more damage they have to do to stagger you. Okay? If, however, you are low health going up against a troll, he's going to stagger you every fucking time. So be well fed, be rested. Always be rested, always be well fed. Yeah? Keep an eye on those meters in the lower left. But yeah, see, if you stagger them, they can't fight back. You just murder them. It's like, whatever. But practice parrying. Practice against gray dwarves, practice against graylings, practice against skeletons are good to practice against. You can parry bows, you can parry arrows, right? I can parry arrows from skeletons. It's just a matter of knowing the timing. It's learning the timing that hurts, yeah? Am I concerned at all about Elder Scrolls 6? Am I over it? Given their leisurely release schedule and my advanced age, Turbo Teller, I don't care about anything that's more than 5 years out. I just don't care. Because I might not be alive by the time it's released. So I don't... I mean, I rarely buy into hype anyway, and not like I'm this... Oh, look at me. I'm this fucking awesome paragon of... Oh, carrot seeds. I'm not this awesome paragon of patience or whatever the fuck. But having a limited budget and... Oh, I've already picked up carrot seeds. I can't be bothered to care. I just can't be bothered to care. We will see what we see. What they do with Starfield will tell me a lot about their priorities. I mean, what they've done with it tells me a lot about their priorities. All right. But I just can't possibly be bothered to care. It's not going to be out for another decade, dude. So, I mean, at best. So, who's yelling? But yeah, I after 76, I'm all, you guys got one more chance. That one chance was Starfield. I don't care what they do anymore. Until unless there are some major staffing changes, I couldn't possibly care less. What are we doing here? What have I got? What am I weighing down with? I got 19 of those. Okay. So we need to go back home. Yeah? We are full because I do not have the belt yet. I do not have the belt yet. Is that far enough from center? It could be in here, theoretically. Okay, so what we're going to do... Ooh, blueberries. $2.99, can I pick up a blueberry? Yeah, I can pick up blueberries. Okay, let's pick up blueberries. We're going to need that for Queen's Jam once I build a cauldron. But yeah, no, I don't have any faith, hope, or, you know, whatever. Unless there is a significant staffing change. Troll Cave! We can kill one of those motherfuckers. Oh, we can't do it right now because we're full. Damn it. Okay. A note on annotating the map. Yeah. You can add text and lettering to everything. What I would recommend is picking the things that are important to you and having a quickly modified way to do that. Okay. Get an example here. Let me do this really fast. I want to pick that up because I'm going to need that. I'm going to get rid of this gray dwarf thing. We'll get rid of the wood. I don't need that much fucking wood. Okay. So in the Black Forest, yeah, there's only one type of ore I care about, and that's copper. Tin, I know you can get tin along the shoreline, so I don't have to mark those. Okay. So I mark copper with a dot. That's it. Right? If, however, there's a cluster of tin that I want to mark, I know the dot means ore. So what I'll do is I'll add a dot, and then I'll go to the icons, and I'll add a little pickaxe. So if I see... Oh, goddammit. So if I see this... If I see that, I know it's tin. If I see this, I know it's copper. There's only two kinds of ore, so I don't need to worry about it. When it comes to marking locations, I will use the skull and crossbones for burial chambers, and I will use them for troll caves. But if it's a troll cave, I add a skull to it, so I know that that's not a burial chamber. I know that this place... Oh, shit. I didn't mark the wrong spot. I'm an idiot. Okay. So go here, mark this, mark that, and do this. But if you can make up a code, you won't have a really cluttered map, right? Because a lot of people will text label everything, and it's almost impossible to read the map after a certain time. Noah's, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Okay, so we're going to go straight back across. We're going to go straight back across this way. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, so we heard a guy, right? Here he is. Right? Here he comes. Come on, buddy. He swings. Block. And you can stand there and he staggers, right? The best part about the staggering is you do more damage. You do like 1.5 times damage. So I can just one-shot the son of a bitch. Just boom, and he's just dead. And I'm like, all right. Oh, I would have been cool if I'd have nailed it. But I didn't, so I'm not cool. Your mouth's full of mushrooms and berry marks. I used to do that as well. But I'll just put a dot with an M on it, yeah? Or a dot with a C, or whatever the fuck. But since I play by myself, mind metal, I don't really need that much supply. Uh-oh. What's this? This is the one... Lord Greyjars, okay. You could eat another bite. Okay, so we're going home, right? My rested bonus is running out. My food is running out. My stamina is low. And we went past this thing here. So now we're going to go here. So now the search is on for burial chambers. We're going to be looking for burial chambers. We need burial chambers. Because I need to make portals. Need to make fucking portals. I need to make a portal here and then run back to my main base. I see you, little fucker. Yeah, hold still. Right about there? Nope. A little higher. There. There we go. I love this Vinewood bow, man. It's such an upgrade from the crude bow. The crude bow's such a piece of shit. Alright, everybody up. Cool. Let's go back to our main fortress here. Main fortress. Alright. First stop, always. Fix your shit. Fix your shit. Always, always fix your shit first. Always, always. Then you do your maintenance, right? Pick up my extra food and go over here. Okay, now I'm going to be needing to make a smelter. And that means I'm going to need to make another rack of chests for that. What have I got in my inventory? So we're going to put the wood away. Put that away. Put this away. Put this away. This is so nice, though, man. Just walking down the thing and just doing that. Okay, it said I had carrot seeds. How did it... When I picked up the carrot seeds, it didn't say carrot seeds. So I must have picked up some before. But I don't know where I put them. Fabulous. Where the fuck did I put the seeds, man? They're not back in my other base. Oh, but hey, you know what? Let's get rid of these motherfuckers right now. Boom. That's my pickaxe. Let's get her done, son. All right, let's get rid of these big lumps on the side of my friggin' gate, my thing here. Okay. I forgot I had a pickaxe now. Let's grab this and smooth over those holes because fuck yes. Level ground, please and thank you. Oh, baby. That's what I want to see right there. Very nice. And we got rid of this big old lump over here, too. Very good. All right. Smooth like a baby's bottom. Uh-oh, what was that? Okay, so you see how the little radar is occluded in the middle of this? What I'll do here is just smack the rise there and then just re-level it, yeah? Nice and smooth. But in general, I don't mark, yeah, mushroom berry marks. A lot of people will do that, and they'll mark the berries and shit. And if I weren't playing by myself, I would too, but I find that I don't need that much stuff, yeah? I don't need that much in terms of food. And so I can make plenty of food for myself for long periods of time. Because the gray dwarf goes in here. Right. Okay. And then the leather and the leather. And then this is... Right. That goes here. That goes here. Right. We're going to put the troll up in here for now. I'm not going to get new... I'm not going to get new... I'm not going to bother with new armor quite yet. Until I can make a whole set, I don't like to bother with it. And then the blood bag... The blood bag goes in here. Yeah, we'll put that in here for now. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to rest, and then we're going to build ourselves our fledgling coming soon. Coming soon. Chest thing. The BGS Fantasy Obsidian takes over the Fallout IP. I'm most fired. Inspired 50 fires. Oh, that's cool. Eh. They're Starfield's that last part, I mean, wishful thinking, certainly. But they've got way too much. Dude, that's got sunk cost fallacy written all over it. Starfield's going to be around pretty much forever. I mean, if they didn't give up on 76, they're certainly not going to give up on fucking Starfield. So that's not a thing that's going to happen, I don't think. Let's see. Let's get our hammer out here, yeah? We don't need this right now. But we do need this. Let's grab that. Red banner. Oh, yeah, because I got the blood bag. Nice! Tia, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. And no one's... I didn't see it come in! Or did I? Did I welcome you? Well, I'm welcoming you again. How do you create a decent game like New Vegas? Less time and less money. Put together a game I can only play for a second time. Yeah, that's well, that's partly you too, you know. I mean, I played it through Outer Worlds when it came. I played it at least twice, I think. But yeah, it didn't have, it was pretty pretty narrow scope. Yeah, let's say that. It was a pretty narrow scope given their history. Okay, we're gonna build the chest right there. Gonna need some wood. Let's grab some wood. Gonna put that in there for now. Let's see here. So now we're gonna need more storage, right? Because I need storage for my metals. Yeah? Now we need storage for the metals. But we don't need much storage for the metals. So what I'm gonna do, and I know I'm gonna have smelters and kilns run it, and they take up a lot of fucking room. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna build our thing right here and put the smelters on one side and the kilns on the other. That'll be our best bet, I think. Yeah. So we're gonna put you there. We're gonna do you here. We're gonna do the same thing we did before, right? Go 1, 2, and 3. And take you out. Use you as a template over here. So yeah, like I said, in terms of the final word, I guess, I don't care what they do anymore. None of it applies to me. None of it interests me. None of it I care about. I care about none of it. And go with God. Vaya con Dios, guys. I hope you can pull it out of the hole that you have. I hope you can pull out of the hole you've dug yourselves into, but I'm not going to be there to watch it. I'm certainly not going to give you money for it. Which is weird because I love 76 and I play the shit out of it. But that's a game that was, like I said, the design was good. It was just technically flawed. And once they fixed the technical flaws, well, it became a good game. And, you know, added the content that fans are screaming for or whatever. Which, I mean, valid. You know, absolutely valid. Okay, we're going to build that there. I'm going to build this here. You can tell I got a system for doing this, right? Efficiency uber alles. That's what we do right here. It's unfortunate. I'll say that. It's unfortunate. But that's what happens when you're not too small and you're not too big. Yeah. When you're that middle ground of you can get pushed around by your... Where you lose the ability to make your own decisions. Yeah. Pretty much. That's pretty much the long and short. You lose the ability to make your own decisions. And then you get everything but the kitchen sink type of gameplay. And it just needed coherence. It needed a vision, and it didn't have one. I'm talking about Starfield, not Outer Worlds. I don't know if Outer Worlds. Okay. All right, let's put the wood away here. And let's take this out. Gonna put this in the ore bin, which is right over here. Yeah, we'll put the ore in there. Okay, put the ore away. Company Heroes, nice. Who was playing that? I've heard of that game before. I don't know who's playing it. Okay, we're gonna leave a pickaxe and, you know, the tools go on the outside. We need to put the tools out here, goddammit. The tools go in here, yeah? Yeah, tools go in there. Okay, so we've got 85 arrows, leather armor. We're gonna go kill some trolls, and we're gonna basically go kill trolls and look for burial chambers. Yeah, that's what we need to fucking do. We need to kill trolls and look for burial chambers. If we find some bees, that'd be kind of nice. I mean, it's not really truly necessary, but it would be nice. All right. So what we're going to do here, since it is about the time, we're going to pause it because this game, of course. Oh, that's another thing, too. Looping back to Pal World. You need to be able to pause. I mean, it's a single player and a multiplayer game, right? But if you're playing single player, you should be able to pause the game, and you can't. It doesn't stop running. I don't like that. So we're going to take a quick intermission here, folks. 3 to 5 minutes. Refill your drink, snack, smoke them if you got them. Stretch like I'm going to. Stretch like I'm going to, dog, old man. Ha ha ha. You got to do this shit now, too. I'll be right back. We are back, and y'all are the real champions. Thank you, Glantry and Groucho, for tag teaming the community showcase. So if you're new to the channel, or if you're watching this later and you've never seen this before, the links you're seeing on the screen are channels of friends of the channel. These are people who are making quality content with a wide variety of different gaming applications, different skill levels, different tactics, and whatever the fuck. Some are pre-recorded, some are post, some are streamed, whatever. And I can almost guarantee if you like this shit, you will find something you like better there. This isn't kind of false humility, man. It's just the facts, man. It's just the facts. And so give them a shout. Give them a look. See what you like. And I got to do something here really quick. I got to the lack of this house not having its finishing touches is bothering me, so I'm going to knock this out real quick. Yeah. Building in this game is so good. I mean, I'm not too... this may be the game that sets the standard for building going forward in terms of its malleability and its flexibility and its ease of use and its tools. I mean, it's just amazing. Okay, I used to be able to snap through there, but top two. Can I get it? Yeah, look at that. Snap it right through there, baby. The top one's on the other side. Yeah, I'm gonna snap it right through there. Look at that. Can't do that in 76, motherfucker. Snap it right through there. That's what I am talking about. That is what I am talking about. So yeah, this game's building is great. I mean, it could be, you know, more fully featured or whatever, but for what it does and what it is, I love it a lot, man. I don't dread building in this game like I do in 76. Although today when I was doing my dailies with Garnet, some guy came shopping. He actually gave me a nice camp on Garnet's camp, and I was like, dude, I got a nice camp thumbs up from a teammate. I was like, that's fucking cool. So here we are. Yeah? Now we're going back into the goddamn forest. Now we are searching. We are going to be searching for... Okay, I need to move these around. So now we're going to the forest. Black forest. Primary weapon's a club. Yeah, blunt's good against everything. It's patrols. This is my secondary for killing trolls. Yeah? I don't need anything else at this point. Yeah? So I rearranged my shortcuts, right? Because I'm on Xbox. So I put the cursor on the shield. And put the cursor on the shield. And we do this. Get our healing on. And we're going to be going out once my rested bonus goes back up to 16 minutes. Now we need to find a goddamn... We need to find some burial chambers, man. Because I need certling cores. It's very good. Yeah, it is. It's... I mean, when I first started playing, it was a little rough. But when they introduced, when they patched the ability to change the snap points, my God, dude. My God, what an amazing quality of life feature that is. Okay, so what are we doing here? Okay, so the Black Forest is down here. Okay, so we're going to go down here, and we're going to start cutting through the fog of war, right? We're basically just going to go left to right, back and forth to the shore to do, to look for copper veins and come on. Run around circles. They really could improve the AI, though. Yeah, fuck you. Also, for people new to the game, combat in this game is very much, at first, it is very much a deliberate, slower-paced affair, because you have to monitor your stamina, right? You ain't gonna go in there and just wade in and start swinging, right? You have to manage the land. You have to manage the tactical situation. Isolate enemies, block them, knock them down, whatever the fuck. Yeah. Okay, here we go. So when you get more than one at a time, that's a problem. If you get more than five, unless you're really good, you're gonna have a lot of problems. Unless you're really good, have a lot of stamina, and a lot of health. If your food game is 100% on point, you will be in good shape. But what we're looking for right now is skeletons, right? These skeletons are guarding... Skeletons are always guarding something. Sometimes it's a tower. That's not of interest to me. The other times they're guarding burial chambers. Burial chambers come in one of three varieties. One variety is the above ground Stonehenge looking one. Right, a bunch of stone slabs on top of stone slabs on top of a stone thing. Right, easy to see, sticks up, whatever the fuck. The second one is a stone stairway looking thing. Right, this is a bunch of stone slabs that are stairways leading to an underground, a burial chamber. Right. Stone slab over the entrance, a bunch of stone slabs as stairs. Pretty easy to see. The third type is a pain in the ass, right? The third type is a burial mound, right? Which is a dome of dirt with a tiny little entrance carved in the side of the hill. These are fucking hard to see, but with that said, once you learn to recognize what it looks like, yeah. Once you learn what the mounds look like, they are super fucking easy to spot. Yeah, you want to do it again? Yeah, bad idea. So, keep an eye out for skeletons. Listen for that little clattering rattle they do. When you hear them, you know something's close by. Also, apparently, apparently the birds, the crows you're hearing, when you're near one of those places, the crows get louder. And there are people I've seen streaming it who are like, I hear a crow. I know something's nearby. And they can just go right to it. I've never been able to do that with Stonehenge last time. They haven't finished it yet. Well, you know, it was middle management engineering. It was CEOs getting in the way. Feature creep. It was feature creep, right? So, hey, man, we got stones. We could add trees, too. Or we could add this. We could add that. The customers want this. Microtransactions for incense and amulets or whatever. It's like, okay. All right. What do we got down there? Water. Okay, there's a bonfire. Way in the distance, right above my cursor, you see a little purple thing in the middle. That is a bonfire. That is a gray dwarf spawner. Yeah. If you need to skill up weapons, those things are fucking awesome. Because as long as you don't kill the fire, they will keep coming out. Okay, what do I want to do? There's a tower down there. It's unlikely there's going to be. Yeah, we're not gonna fuck with that. We're gonna stay on our side of the street here. We're gonna go down a little bit, and then we're gonna go back the other way. We're gonna see if we can find something here. And yes, I'm running. Yeah, caveman outfit, fucking Stone Age gear, and I'm just like, whatever. I'm gonna run through here. I need these guys to come out and fight me, cause I need trolls, man. I need to get me some more trolls. I need about, I don't know, 40 or 50 fucking skins to get the whole. Oh, mountains already. Okay, you just keep going, buddy. Okay, fucking mountains here. This ain't good. So now we're looking, right? We're looking for blueberries. We're looking for carrot seeds. We're looking for copper veins. That's not a copper vein. Doesn't have the little glowy parts in it. We're looking for trolls. We're listening for skeletons. We're looking for towers. We're doing all kind of harvesting shit out this way. Not seeing a lot here though. This is not promising. Okay, there's a little tower wreckage here. Come on, buddy. Whoop! Didn't get the timing down. See? Gotta get the timing right. You don't get the timing right, they'll hit you. Which is why when you're practicing, practice against weak shit. So if they get through your defenses, they don't kill you. Ooh, a chest. What's in here? Everything. Okay, we'll just take everything. Ah, skeletons. Good. Okay, what's it gonna be, boys? What's it gonna be? Where's the mound? Is there a mound here? Or is the entrance? Now we look, right? He came because we were fighting. And he came from this direction. So now we're gonna go real cool. And we're gonna listen for another skeleton. There's a copper deposit. This is good. Oh, is it here? There it is right there. See? Okay, arrows. Where is he? The skeletons, you can block their arrows. Here, let's run behind the tree here real quick. Get him out here. When he pulls and draws, he'll draws. There's a creek, right? Creek, parry. Boom! So you can parry projectiles. You just gotta know the animation. You gotta learn the animation. Okay, so here it is. Here's the slab one, right? This is covered by a copper vein. He came because we were fighting. Wouldn't a firefight can be awkward? Well, no, the thing is, how this game works with the enemy detection is by sound, yeah? Running makes a little noise. Sneaking makes the least amount of noise. Running, just jogging around, makes noise. Sprinting makes more noise. Jumping makes more noise. Fighting makes noise. And then, of course, harvesting, hacking down trees, hacking up things, makes a shitload of noise. Okay. So when you're harvesting, like this copper vein or whatever the fuck, they will come running, dude, from, you will not believe how far away. So we're at 99, right? We're going to take a chance. The problem here is I have to clear this out a little bit to get in there, because that's the entrance, right? But this copper deposit is covering it, which means when I come out, I'm going to be buried inside a copper deposit. So we got to clear this out a little bit. Look how long this is taking. Good, we got a nice shear on that one. So we're going to get this one, right? We got to open this up so I can get back out when I go back in there, yeah? And hopefully my pickaxe don't break before I fucking get this out. I don't normally do this, right? I don't normally mine a copper deposit like this, but I've got to get this out of the way. Because if I don't, I will not be able to get back out. See, it says enter. And you can see the stairs here, right? When I come out, I'm going to be like right about here. So I'm going to clear this out here. Skill goes up quick when you're resting, so keep that in mind. But hear them? They're coming, right? Because I'm mining. I'm making all this fucking noise. Yeah. Come on, big fella. Come on. Come on. Sit down. Motherfucker. Okay. This should be enough room, but just in case, let's go ahead and get rid of this chunk right here. Wow, that was easy. Okay, cool, this is clear. Now we're gonna go into the skeleton zone. Oh, the skeleton zone. Burial chambers, all right. I'm not gonna bother fucking sneaking, I can take these guys, come on. I see you, buddy, come on. Whatever. See, the last time we were in here, right, we got our asses kicked, right? This time, however, it's going to be a little bit different. Because I got a shield, I've got armor. Is there a door here? There's a door here. What we are looking for is we're looking for a spawner. We're looking for that. The evil bone pile. Because whenever there's an evil bone pile, there's always a loot room next to it. Look at that. Yeah, baby. And now it's going to show me where the nearest elder is. And I'm hoping that he's not across the fucking ocean. Let's see where he is. Ah, you son of a bitch. Are you kidding me? Okay, so the other one's got to be down here. There's got to be another elder down here. That guy is too far away. I'm going to do way too much fucking swimming on that one. That's going to suck. All right. But yay, we got some loot. We got it in the first fucking room. How about that? So now we're going to get a bunch more Sirtling cores. Because every portal takes two of them. It takes two of them, 10 eyes, 10 gray dwarf eyes, and yeah, I see it. But see, you can go ham in here, man, because skeletons are weak to blunt, and I got a club, so I'm just gonna murder the shit out of these guys. Okay, we came in that way. I do the typical hug the right wall, and typical dungeon crawl, hug the right wall shit, right? Wow, this one's pretty involved. Oh, there we go. That's the business right there. Come on, boys, anybody else in here? Look at this, we're getting the loots. All right, out we go. But see, now it's a little bit more manageable, right? Now that I have fucking armor and decent weapons and a decent club, and I'm rested in. I should probably reapply my food here. Okay, upgraded club. Yeah, baby, that's how we do. That's empty, okay. And out we go. And that's the first wing, right? Okay, now for the second wing. There's always three wings. So while we're going through here and I'm doing this shit, a note about procedural generation. A lot of the complaints about Starfield are that they use procedural generation too much or whatever. And I'm gonna tell you that procedural generation is a tool, okay? If you know how to use a tool, it is very effective. If, however, you are incompetent or incapable, it can kill you. This game here, what? No Sirtling cores? Are you so, I was gonna say, man. Whenever there's an evil bone pile, there's always Sirtling cores. But like this game here, right? it's procedural generated. The maps are all procedural generated. These little dungeons are all procedurally generated. But they're interesting. Yeah, they're fairly simple. You can figure it out. You can figure out the their rules and their sizes and whatever the fuck. But it's interesting, right? Because it's the same elements over and over, but it's how they're done that makes the difference. And proc gen is super good when you've got good design. Yeah. When you got good design, it's good stuff. If you don't have good design, well, the tool's only as good as people are wielding it, right? Oh, a fucking ghost. Alright, you killed me last time, dude, but I think I'm gonna get you this time. I'm switching to spear. There we go. Spear did a little more damage. Yeah, last time he ate our lunch, this time I'm like, whatever. That's one thing this game does really well, too. You get immediate results for increasing your power. The difference between your abilities and capabilities with the same skill level, noticeable. Yes. Like, we're coming in here and the ghost killed my ass last time, so I was in a rag tunic with a level 1 club. Come in here, I got every weapon, all my armor and shit. I'm like, yeah, whatever, dude. You want some of this, Mr. Mosty Ghosty? I got something for you, motherfucker. Come here. I got some payback. Okay, so we're all done here. We emptied this place out. The only thing that respawns in these is... The yellow mushrooms. The enemies don't. The enemies in the loot don't respawn. Okay, now it's dark. Yeah. Now it's dark. Now, the enemies get stronger. There are more of them. And I am cold. Yeah. Which means my stamina comes back slower, and I'm almost not resting. You can survive at night in a biome that you had just entered. But you have to be super fucking careful. Right? You don't sprint, you don't jump, you don't harvest. You go nice and slow. Yeah? You go nice and slow. Right now, we could probably stand to go back home. Yeah, we're close enough. We'll go back home. I got, 10 Certling Cores that time? And we have some copper. We have three copper. 246, shit weighs 10 pounds a piece. I could carry 5 more. Come on, carry more if I drop the stone. Okay. So now we're gonna do something we really should not fucking be doing. And that is mining at night, particularly as close to the mountains. But I need copper. I need copper really bad. Okay, away we go. Let's make some noise, ladies and gentlemen. Bring all the boys to the yard, yeah? You don't feel rested anymore, and it's cold. The only way this could be worse is if it was raining. But we killed the spawn in the immediate vicinity. Okay, I see a shaman over. No, that's a plant. I hear them coming, man. They're like, oh no, I hear mining, yeah. So whenever they come, stop what you're doing. Oh, brute. I don't like these guys. Come on. And see, what happens is you get all the trash in here, right? So you're sitting here, and they're eating up your fucking stamina while you're trying to get rid of the big guy. Now I'm completely out of stamina, right? So I gotta just sit here and just get my stamina back. Alright. Oh, fuck you guys. 2 shaman and a brute and 2 guys? Yeah, we're gonna stand here and get our stamina back. Fuck that. Could you camp in the dungeon? Yeah. If I had a hammer, I could build a campfire here in the lobby and get a comfort level of 3. And get that back. But I don't really care about that. I can do it with what I've got, because I just ate. Yeah. Yeah, man, fuck you. You want to prioritize shaman, because they will heal these guys. Quit running around in circles, you dipshit. Yeah, thank you. There we go. Beat him like a lug. He owed me money. Okay, so I'm clearly overburdened. I got four. I'm going to get rid of the stone. I'm going to get rid of the wood. Absolutely get rid of the stone, get rid of the wood. Just drop it on the ground. The game will recycle them. Was a time where it wouldn't, but now it does. So, okay. So here we go. This a copper deposit? Yeah, there's one right here. We're going to do this till it breaks. Skinny dip with piranha. It's just, it's a calculated risk, right, dog? It's just, I know that this is going to make a shitload of noise, and they're going to come running. Okay? And I am not rested, and I am not, here they come again, yeah? They will continue to come. My age is difficult to get it. Well, they got pills for that now, apparently. Okay, how many copper do I have? Six? Here they come again. Let's switch to the spear this time. Yeah, you guys want to get salty? Come on. Okay. Got all that. Everybody done? Nice. Nope. Still making noise over here. Because the fighting brought him, and now there's two shaman. Nice. Yeah? Die. Okay, are we fucking done now? Can I get back to what I was doing, please? Thanks. Get rid of that and that. Six copper. Axe is on the verge of breaking. If I can get one more. Because the thing is, to make one bronze, you need two copper and one tin. Yeah? Okay, how many is that? I didn't get any copper out of that. And here they come again. Come on, boys. You want it? Come and get it, dude. I ain't got all night. I mean, I do have all night. I got plenty of food. Yeah, I see you. Come on, piece of shit. Let's go. Yeah, fuck you. Come from both directions, huh? All right. Keep the entrance of the thing at my back. Tactically sound. And now the fighting will bring more. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Stunlock! Okay, that it? Alright, let's drop the wood and the stone. I don't think this pickaxe is going to be able to do much more than this. But we only got six copper. We didn't even get copper out of that last one. That's some bullshit, dude. Any other veins that are close? Is that one? Did it say? Thought it said. Okay, we'll try this one. Hopefully we can get this before the pickaxe breaks. It'll probably break before I get this done. Oh, we did it. Copper ore times two. Booyah. Okay. But again, this is why you rotate between your weapons, right? You can see my club is almost half broken, but I've got a perfectly fresh spear and a perfectly fresh axe, yeah? So, I could do this, come on. And then we wait. Get our stamina back while he dances around, right? Another shaman. Thankfully, they're nice and squishy. So if you drill them quick, it shouldn't be a problem. All right, we done? We're at 237, huh? I can pick up some of this wood and some of this stone. Wood times four. Yeah, we could do that. Pick up some stone too. You are carrying too much. Okay. How much am I over with? Nine? What have I got in here that I can get rid of? I'll get rid of the wood. Because I need the stone to build the, I need the stone to build the, Stone times 42? Oh, Jesus. Well, you know what? Let's do that again. Let's be smart. Stone times 50. Stone times 7. Yeah. So what we can do is we can throw down the 10. Split the 50. 327. It's 2 per, right? So I need to drop 14. So what we do is we drop 14, split it, drop that. Now we're $2.99. All right, off we go. Let's go home. With our first batch of copper, a bunch of stone, and yeah. But we survived the night in the forest. How are the bees? Are they still happy? If they're happy, they're producing. I think the bees will be happy. We're going to check when we get there. We're going to harvest our... We're going to go in there. We're going to do our maintenance, right? We're going to harvest our honey. Put all our shit away. And we're going to see about building a smelter and a... see about building a smelter and a... Yeah, they're buzzing, so they're happy. You really don't have to worry about if they're happy when you first put them down, right? So you come up here, right? We grab them. Well... No, I had to put shit away first, sorry. I had to put stuff away first because I am too heavy. Yes, I am too heavy. Put all that away. And then in here, put away the stone. And no good wood there. We didn't get any of those. We got these, though. I know we got some of those, and we definitely got some of these. There we go. We got lots of that. Very nice. Okay, and then the blueberries go here. I'll put the thistle in here for now. And then those things go in there. And then this goes here. Arrows go up there. Right. Somehow we have 9 copper now. Not sure how that happened, but okay. So now we do is put that in there. Okay, let's go check the bees. Still can't find anyone to join. A lot of people keep their servers private, yeah, or, you know, because people are kind of dicks, whatever. But if you go to the subreddit, if you go to the Valheim subreddit, you can probably find someone who's willing to invite you along. The bees are happy. The bees are happy. Yes, they are happy. Very happy. Good happy bees. Okay. Now to get this fucking party started, yeah? Let's drop 5 of those in here. Yeah. You hate Reddit? Well, they probably have a Discord, too. I mean, there's probably a Valheim Discord somewhere. The developers might have it. They might even have a matchmaking service, for all I know. Might be worth a shot taking a look. See what you can find in the resources land. Okay. So we're going to grab this. We're going to grab some stone. How much I got in here? 48. That should be enough. And we're going to grab all of our Sirtling cores, which are here. Because I think I need 5 apiece. Okay, so now we're going to build. Yeah, time to build. Well, time to assemble, really. So now we go to crafting, and we have 20 stone and 5 Sirtling cores apiece. Yeah? We're going to put this monster, which is a bitch and a half to place. Wow, it really is a bitch to place, isn't it? Push it back there. Boy, it doesn't like to be close to anything, does it? This motherfucker takes a ton of room, man. Good lord, dude. I want it to face that way. Okay, we're gonna have to move this thing at some point because this is just completely unfucking acceptable. I'm gonna put you here. God damn, boy, it's really fucking finicky. Well, I guess this is going to have to do for now then, huh? Like right here? Yeah, we'll put it there. And then we'll put the smelter over here. These things are way easier to place. I'm going to put it right there, right? Okay, now to load this thing up with... Hey, Bert, what's up, buddy? Deposit your raw ore in the furnace, it'll melt away all the impurities. You will need coal. You will need coal. You will absolutely need coal for everything, dude. Because, and the thing is, all this wood I've got in here, yeah, this is going away. I can tell you right now. You will use so much fucking wood filling up this charcoal kiln. But they did, you used to have to push the button every time to load this thing. Now you just hold the button down. Quality of life, yes, please and thank you. Okay, and then in here, what we're going to do is we're going to take three of these. Yeah, three of those. Because the capacity is 10, right? And six of these. And we're just going to load it up first. It won't turn on. It won't turn on until I've got enough charcoal. So what we're going to do now is the exciting part. The exciting part of kilning, which is cutting down fucking trees. We're going to be doing a lot of this. Time to deforest the entire goddamn vicinity. Because you will be going through so many trees, my friends. So many trees. We're going to chop some fucking trees. Okay. I'll pick up these raspberries for later. Alright, trees. Where are my trees? Time for some timber, baby. So while the kiln's running, what I'm doing is I'm chopping down trees to feed the kiln. Yeah. But we're getting our axe, we're getting our skill up. Yeah, so what the hell. Okay. Nope, didn't get lucky. Why is there a tree knocked down over here, though? Oh, because it's in the birch tree. Okay, we're going to leave you there for now. We're not going to deal with your bullshit for the time being. We're just going to chop down more trees. See if you get lucky with a good fall. First 10 coal from cooking. Yeah, so did I back in the day. Because I didn't know how cooking worked, right? I didn't know that little second fizz was what mattered, right? So I was, I had a lot of coal. Yeah, whatever, Piggy. I'll get your ass in a minute. Just come on back. I think the tree killed him. Oh, that was fun. Woo, come on, big boy. Cut this shit. Now, the axe is a pretty wide arc, right? So, like, these three trees here, let's see how many I can get. I got two of them. Didn't get the third one. But if you practice, you will get the hang of, you'll get the instinctive knowledge of the axe's arc. Same thing with the club or the mace or whatever. So now that he's got the ability to do this, right? I used up all those certling cores to make my kiln thing. I can make one portal because I only have three left, right? Which means I have to find another burial chamber. But priority one is making something out of. Is making my first bronze ingot, because then I'll unlock like everything, man. I'll unlock all the shit I can make out of bronze. And one of the things you can make out of bronze, of course, is a cultivator. The cultivator lets you plant seeds. No, don't you do that. Planting seeds is a finicky, time-consuming thing, but it is the way to get the best food items in the game. Because you will need carrots, and you will need turnips. Once you hit the swamp, you will need turnips. And then after that, I'm sure there's other foods and other biomes that I haven't gotten that far yet. So, you know, nice shot. Dude, Croucho, dude, it would boggle your mind if you knew how much wood I have chopped down in this fucking game over the years. Feeding four characters furnaces, man. Like, there was one day I took out my guy. I literally wore out three flint axes doing nothing but chopping wood. Because they have the belt, right? There's this merchant you can find, right? He only spawns in the Black Forest. He only spawns a certain distance away from the starting spot. And you can sell him the amber stuff, and you can sell him the rubies, right? You can sell him the amber pearls, the rubies, and silver necklaces if you find any. Yeah, he'll buy those. He'll give you coins, yeah? With those coins, you can buy things from him. The most important thing you can buy from him costs 950 coins, and it is called Megan Jord or some shit like that. I don't know how to pronounce it. It is basically a belt that takes up an inventory slot. It has 150 year carry capacity. This thing is the most valuable fucking item in the game when you were starting off in the Bronze Age. Yeah. Because you need to carry ore. That shit's fucking heavy, man. Yeah. even now, my best I can carry, I don't know, maybe 35 ore at best. Yeah. Because I got to carry all my other equipment, right? All my other gear and shit. So, having the ability to carry more shit, hugely helpful. But you have to find him. And he's in random spots because it's procedurally generated, right? He could be on a completely separate con. I have no idea where he is. I just know that he's in a Black Forest biome somewhere. Same thing with Hildur. Yeah? Hildur is his sister. She sells clothing items and something called an iron fire pit. I'm not quite sure. It's cheap, it's only 75 coins, but I don't know what its function is. I mean, I guess it's a fire, yeah. I haven't bought one yet. But she only spawns in the meadows, and she only spawns over 3,000 units away from your spawn point. You know what? I am gonna cut this thing down. I don't care. You need the wood, baby. La-di-da-di. But now we're in the advanced foraging, yes? Advanced foraging. Where we're going to be making... Can I get both these trees in one swing? Ooh, in stereo! Also, the pickaxe is nice. You can clear these rocks out. Yeah. So if you're building out somewhere and you got a rock in your way, you can literally just hack the rock up. Really nice. Very convenient. The bees are being. Are we done yet? Yep. Light's not on anymore, so zip. Look at that. Coal pile sign, black banner. Yeah, baby. And yellow banner. Okay, so now we feed this thing. We need 18 in here. All right, we put that in there. All right, we put the leftovers in here. We take out another 25, and we do it again. We're going to feed the forest this charcoal kiln, my friends. Put the wood back and get the fuck out of here. Go back to chopping more trees. We'll make this the last one because I don't have any other ore I can deal with right now. Yeah, I'll grab this. And this looks pretty dense. Maybe we get a good fall. We can knock over a couple more trees here with this one. And then we'll go back to the Black Forest, look for more Surtling cores, and hunt some fucking trolls. Actually, I should just go to that cave. All right. Come on, baby. Get that wood. There we go. La-di-da-di. Now, the nice thing about the little trees, they give you resin a lot. So if you need resin, chop down these little scrubby trees, you'll be fine. Yeah, we'll get this one. We're here. What the hell? Welcome back, Noel. I'm sorry I missed you coming back in. I was reading Groucho's nice shot, and I completely overlooked it because I'm an idiot. Now, these are beet seeds, right? Apparently, you can plant trees. I've never done it, so I don't know how it works. But that's a thing you can do. So far, I haven't had to worry about running out of wood, so... Because what I'll do sometimes, I'll just make a logging camp, right? I'll make a base, I'll make a fort, in a place that's really dense forest, and I'll just hack up everything around it, teleport the shit back, and get my remote, You can also parry with a weapon out. It just doesn't block a lot of damage, yeah? Doesn't block a lot of damage. Which obvious because it's a weapon, it's not a shield. Come on, boys, let's get some more wood. But see, it's taking him fewer swings, right? He's actually clearing this wood out a lot faster than he used to. Because his skill's getting better, right? He's better at destroying the forest. But there is no shortage of wood, man. Come on, dude. I really do wish they'd let him swing down below his knees, though. Okay, Birch Tree, I'm coming for you once I get a bronze axe, homie. We're not rolling anymore, Bubba Boy. Bubba Booey. Okay. So now I need to make a forge. Crafting. Forge. Can I make a forge yet? No, I can't, because I need copper? Is it copper? I need copper, I think. I need copper. Go back over here. Pick these up. Broop. Yeah, buddy. Let's get our ore and put it in here. Get the copper in there. All right. Put the coal away. And then put everything else away, yeah? Make sure we have our stuff for later, later usage. And the seeds go down here. And then the leather goes here. The boar meat goes here? No, here. And then the straw raspberries go there. Right, okay. I swear to God, that automatic organizing thing, best quality of life feature they ever fucking added. That and the snap points. Saves so much time. So much time. All right, and here's the tin coming out. New material tin. Yes, I know. I'm gonna put this in here. Okay, we've only got one more to go. Yeah. Only got one more to go. So come on, Tin. We're going to wait for you. Now we're going to see if we can build the forge yet. There it is. We need stone, coal, wood, and six. We need to use all the copper. We just need to use all the copper that we... That we just need to use all the copper that we just got. But at the same time, we also need a workbench near it. Right? You saw that, right? A forge requires a workbench. So what we have to do, we'll take the copper out, weighs 72 pounds, weighs 12 pounds apiece, yeah? We're going to take that out. Now what we're going to do is we're going to build a workbench and a forge right here, yeah? Or I could just build it right here, actually. No. I'm going to... So I could build the forge and workbench right here, right? But I'm going to build it over here instead. And the reason for that is I have a workbench in here already, right? This workbench has a radius where monsters won't spawn. If I put the other workbench over here, it doesn't really extend the, the safe zone. But if I put it against the back wall over there, it totally does. So we're going to build it over there. And that means we need more fucking wood. We need more wood to be building all the shit we need to be building here, yes? So we're going to grab this and this. You're carrying too much. Of course I am. Not by much, though. Oh, well, I put the... well, let's go ahead and put away three of these. Yeah, one, two, three. Once I start building, it'll be fine. Okay, so now we're going to build it in this space right here. Now, the problem with doing that is I've got my fucking smelter here. I'm probably going to need more than one. So what I may end up doing is moving the smelters over here and just building the whole workbench against this back wall. That's the best move, actually. I'm an idiot. I can't pick that up. Let's drop the wood. Let's just throw you right there for now. Yeah. Let's pick you up. Let's put the smelter back over here. Yeah. Put you there against the wall, right there. All right, do that. Get rid of this. Pick up this wood. And pick these up. Yeah, put them in here. Okay. So now, party time number two. How are we going to do this? We've got... What? I've got... God damn it. This is an angled one. So straight, 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 straight. I got five straight. Is that going to be enough? Is that going to be enough? It's going to have to do for now. So now what we're going to do is we have to start spacing this out. We got that one there. Okay, we're going to go this way. And then we're going to go... Is that... No, I can't build it there. I got to build it here. Because otherwise I won't be able to get in there, yeah? That's not going to be big enough. So let's move it out to the outside over here like that. Right. And then we're going to build a workbench on this side right here. Will that do? I need a space. You know what? Fuck this. I need to sleep. We need to get the sun back up, man. I can't see. All right. Let's go ahead and take a nap. He got a hard day of building ahead of him. All right, off we go. For more building, let's close our door too. I don't need anybody coming in here when I'm building. All right, the sun will be up in a minute, so we'll worry about it in a minute. So we're gonna do that, then we're gonna do, no, not that one, this one. So if I do that and I put the workbench down, how much room do I have on the outside there? If I do it like this, see, because what I want to do, right, is I want to use this workbench as my main workbench. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here. And we're going to tear this. God damn it. I'm going to tear this down. We're carrying too much. Man. Ugh. We should be able to make it across the walkway. I like how it says encumbered instead of over encumbered, because, you know, encumbered means you're overburdened, right? So the term over encumbered means you're over encumbered, which is like what? Okay, so I always like to tuck this thing behind here, right? Get it next to the workbench so it's out of the way. And then we go back over here. We'll get rid of this. Wood deer hide. God damn it. I just broke something. Oh, it was just the roof. That's fine. I'll put it back. Put it back right there. We'll pick up the leather scraps and the flint. Now we waddle back across here and do it again. It's like a double negative. Yeah, well, it's redundant. Yeah, it's redundant. ATM machine, PIN number, VIN number. It's redundant. Okay, so we're going to leave that there. Now we're going to build the thing right here. Build this right outside. Notice how nicely it goes right through the wall there. Very good. I like that. Put it right there. Okay. So we've got that going. Is that going to be enough fucking room for the... Well, let's just put it down and see what we can do here. So I put that there, and crafting. I need stone and coal. Okay. 4 stone, 4 coal. So let's get the coal. 4 of those. And then 4 stone. Hopefully I've got 4 stone left. Oh, I do. Barely. All right. Time to build a forge. We're going to put it right over here. This thing is tiny. What you want to do is definitely leave room on one side of it, because at some point you're going to get a bellows, and the bellows works really good when it's right next to it on the left. The forge bellows does not have a very big range. Now watch all the new crafting recipes. That's it, because I haven't built bronze, because I just used all my copper. All right, so let's go ahead and cover these bastards. Because until they get shelter, they're not going to be usable. Stop bottom here and there. I'm going to do here and here. We're going to do here and here. I'm going to do here and here. Right? Right. Then I'm going to put the shallow roof on, which is over here. Just like that. And snappy at the top. Bottom, top, bottom. Put you like that, right? Put you way up high. Why do I put it up so high? Because I'll put a second floor in here where I will put all the equipment that won't fit. Because the thing about the various crafting stations, I don't know if you can see it or not. God damn it. When you hover the crafting station, now it's not doing it. Why is it not doing it? Oh, because I'm not building it. So let's do this. Okay. You see a little sparkly line that's coming out of it? That's going towards the workbench? Every workbench enhancement, every forge enhancement, has to have a clear line between the item and the workbench, the thing it affects, right? Which means if I try and place something between the two, it won't work. It'll turn red. You won't be able to place it, right? So you have to have a clear line that's not obstructed, like right here. See, it's obstructed by the leather, by the tanning rack. But I pull it down here, it's not obstructed by the tanning rack. Yeah? I didn't figure this out for a really long time. I had to look it up. I'm like, why does it fucking not place? Because it has to have a clear line of sight, a clear path to the workbench in question. This means once you get three or four or five of these things piled up, you're either going to have them all over the place on the ground, or you just build them above it, right? Make a second floor, put all the shit in above it, and call it a day. Because you can put them, you know, however you want above them, because they won't collide with each other to get to the workbench. That's all. Just a little tip from someone who took way too long to figure that shit out. Okay, little mans, I see you, buddy. How you doing? You want to come up? We're almost there, bubby. Don't worry. You're all right. So now we're going to do this here. And bottom one. Yeah, cool. Just going to put a big roof way the fuck over the top of it for now. And you'll notice that these are orange and yellow. You're all, why are they orange and yellow? They're attached to the wall. Yeah, but the wall is green. The wall's not blue. Yeah. So now we need supports. Yeah, we need supports for these things. And I think if I do this one, and then put some X's underneath it. Yeah? No. We're going to do that. We're going to put the X here. Because the game does keep track of structural supports. Yeah? We're going to do that. And we're going to put this one up here. Yeah? Did it work? Now it's green. And that one's greenish yellow, but that's okay. How is Kitty? He's fine. He's coming into his own. He's yelling a little bit more. I'm rubbing him right now to keep him happy. I still haven't quite figured him out. He stares at me sometimes, and I know he's trying to tell me something, but I have no idea what it is. So that's a thing. Guess let's go ahead and build the floor up here right now. Let's just do that. We got plenty of wood to do it. So let's just build the floor above here. He uses his legs about the same as he always does. I don't think he's ever gonna walk. I'm at the point now where how he acts and how he behaves and how he operates, he gets up on his legs a lot, yeah, but he never pushes off with them. He just paddles with them. And I got a feeling that means that the signals between his kitty brain and his kitty legs is severed, and it's just nerves don't regenerate, you know. So he's gonna be Mr. Paddles all his life, and that's fine. Like I was saying before, he's a companion, dude. The use of his legs is not a requirement. Yeah, it's a nice to have for his own comfort, but he can still perform his companionship duties without legs. And I'll be cleaning up shit off the floor for my entire life. I mean, that's how it's gonna be. Whatever, it's fine, you know. He's fine. He's got a lot more energy now that we've. I think his energy levels are related to that Bartolinosis shit he had, and now that he's cured of it, now that we've done the doxycycline, we did like 4 weeks of it, put in his food and shit, and. When it was done, when we got done with the cycle, his energy levels were noticeably higher. So I'm thinking that might have been part of it. Yeah? I don't know for sure. I have no way to know because I can't ask him. But he does okay, man. He does okay. He's a good boy. And then we're going to put the X's across the front here. I see you snipping your tail, little man. The thing is, the thing about it with him is that I can't tell if I can't read his mood from his tail.
Yeah.
He is called Little Mans. Yeah, that's, well, that's the thing about cats, right? You don't name a cat. Cats tell you what their name is when they trust you enough. This can take a long time. Excuse me, one second. Clearing my throat there. So I just called him Little Mans as the first thing that came to mind as a placeholder, since I know it's going to be a placeholder. And he'll be fine. Bottom one. I need bottom one. There. So I'm going to put that there. I'm going to put this over here. But eventually, he'll tell me his name like Mr. Beans did. I'll say something someday, and he'll look at me, and I'm like, okay, that's your name now, then. That is your name now. Okay, is this going to be sufficient? I think this will be sufficient. I'm going to take the roof off when I need to do stuff. So I need to fix stuff, right? Good. Let's do Roomba. Yeah, no, we're not going to name him Swiffer, dude. What do I want to do here? I want to make some torches here. Let's make some torches. I want to put one right there, but I don't want it to snap. How do I do that? There isn't a one wide piece that I can use that's that. Can I snap? Will this snap to its outside here? No, it won't. But if I do this, unlock it, put it inside it, you gotta love that, right? Okay, so we do that, line it up as best I can. Does that look the same height? Looks pretty good. All right, we turn snapping back on, and now we snap this piece here, and then take this out. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. But yeah, they named him his name at the shelter was Forest. And I'm like, that's kind of cruel, guys. He doesn't know, you know. But he's a Star Killer. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. How is it going? We are moving into the Bronze Age today, Star Killer. We murdered Ike there a couple times, and got some pickaxes and. Next week, I'll probably play this guy a little bit and just do a bunch of mining. Yeah. But for now, what I'm going to do is put a couple of torches here because I want some light. Furniture, torch. Yeah, that's good. And since it's daytime, I can see where it goes. So we're going to put this right there. I'm going to move over here and put it right there. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay. Add a couple of torches so I can see in there. Bob Ross. Nathan, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Just a couple cheats. Now, this I haven't used. We cleared the environment last week because I couldn't fucking see and I was getting irritated. But this guy so far has been pretty straightforward and pretty legit. Yeah. Now, here's the question. Can I make a cauldron yet? I can. I need 10 tin. 10 tin, huh? Do I have 10 tin? I do. Let's put 10 tin in there. 10 tin. We're gonna put 10 tin in the smelter. Yeah, and then we're gonna get 20 coal. Your books and plants. The thing is, cats respond fairly well to correction as long as it's not punitive. People who physically discipline cats get really angry, skittish cats. But if you generally give them positive reinforcement and only like raise your voice when he's in trouble, they learn pretty quick to stay. I mean, I trained Mr. Beans. He learned to stay out of the kitchen, dude. Literally, the cat would not go in the kitchen. He knew where the kitchen lines were and would not go in there. Of course, until I turned my back. Because, you know, when the cops aren't looking, it's not a crime, right? So he would go in there and get busy, get crazy and shit. But he knew, right? I didn't have to beat him. I didn't have to do whatever. Little man's, yeah, he's doing fine. He's cruising around. He's looking for attention. He does his kitty TV, plays with his toys, and drags his ass a little thing. He still has a problem going using the litter box. And I was trying to figure out if there was a pattern to it, but there's not, unfortunately. Unfortunately, there's no pattern to it. He just sometimes pees and poops on the floor, and I'm just gonna have to clean it up. And every now and then I'm gonna wipe his butt because he, you know, gets stuck in it because he can't use his back legs, you know. He'll do good for like 2 weeks, and then 4 days in a row it'll be a disaster. I'm like, I don't understand why. What's going on here, dude? Why are you doing this? But he's a good boy. He is very good at what he's supposed to do, which is provide companionship. He's got himself a good life.
Yeah.
I just got to get his respiration checked out because I really don't like how fast he breathes, man. And I am not getting good answers from the vet on what the problem could be. So we may need to schedule a time to take him to a specialist again just to figure out what the fuck is going on. Yeah. And give me an explanation of why. Because if it's something's going to shorten his life, I need to know. But other than that, he's good. Yeah, it's hard to have a dog in an apartment, man. It is hard to have a dog in an apartment. Unless it's, you know, like a purse dog. Yeah, you know what? I am going to put these up here. I don't really need to, but I don't like those exposed floors. So we're going to do that. And I don't like those anymore, so let's pull those back down. Alright. Got an open air. Oh. Skill improved jump 22. Okay, so we're just gonna put these across the front. A little decoration, yeah. I can hang my trophies on this, yeah? We can do that. Sure. Come on, get in there. And here. I mean, that's reasonable. That looks like, it's not what you want. Let me guess, German Shepherd? German Shepherd, Mr. Historian? it wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't surprise me. Okay, what do we got here? Let's put that in the back, yeah? Put it as back as far as we can. Yes, we're golden, yeah. German Shepherd. See, I knew. So here's all the shit we can make now, right? But we can't make nothing, right? We can only make bronze. Once we make our first bronze ingot, like 90 things will unlock. It's insane. There's a ton of crap you can build on the thing, on the bronze. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do this, and then we're gonna take these. This here, I'm gonna fill this back up, add some more wood to the fire. Okay, I'm gonna pick up the tin, we're gonna stick it in the finished thing there. Okay, la-di-da-di. This is not the best setup, but I have to move that kiln, man. I just don't like them facing that way. Okay, so there's the storage, right? This storage will hold us well to the Bronze Age. If we need more storage, I can just push it down two more and put in, what, 16? No. Two more is 12 more. I can put 12 more storage containers in here with very little difficulty, right? Expand it down and just put two more segments of six apiece, right? Just stick those right there. And just move this down a little bit and whatever. So there's our forge, there's our workshop. Here's our processing. Yeah, I gotta definitely turn that kiln around. But we got a forge working, right? Once we get bronze, we'll be able to make, actually, do we have, what else we got in crafting? Okay, so we can make a forge cooler for 10 copper and 25 fine wood. But the first thing we're gonna be making, I can tell you right now, the first thing I'm gonna be making is a bronze axe. No question, no two ways about it, we're making a bronze axe. Yeah, got to make a bronze axe. Now we're gonna take all this out. Yeah, do we have enough coal yet? We do not. We need four more. Come on, man. We're gonna sit here and we're gonna wait for four more. And while we're doing that, I'm gonna go do little files. So I'll be right back, folks. All right, how we doing here? Let's see what we got. So what we're going to do for the next, I don't know. We got 21. Okay, so we need 18 in here, right? So we put 9 of these in here. And then we need twice as much ore, coal, as we do ore. So now we need 18, right? Put the coal in there, put this in here, put that in there. Okay, so what we're going to do now, we're asleep. I'm going to show you what mining copper looks like and why it is hellish. We're going to take this, right? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all my picks out of here. And I mean all of them. Right? Because we're going to be breaking every single one of them. We're going to be breaking them all. Let's rest. How hard is the first boss of a new player? What should you bring to the fight? Were you here when we fought? Well, I fought him on the stream. We beat him earlier in the stream. Generally, as a new player, you want to get the best food you can, the best armor you can, the best weapons you can. In this case, it means rank 3 of whatever. What that means is you're going to need a workbench, you're going to need a chopping block, and you're going to need the tanning rack. You're going to need all 3 upgrades. Yeah. Then once you get that done, you're going to need a bunch of flint and wood and leather scraps to make... I mean, you could just use... I used a spear. What kind of armor? I was using rank 2 leather helmet, rank 2 leather tunic, and a rank 1 leather pants. I had an armor level of 10. You can see it up there on the right. The little tab there on the top of the screen between the main inventory and the description. It says 10. I had an armor level of 10. So leather armor will do you just fine. I wouldn't try him in a rag tunic. I would try him in leather armor. Actual leather armor would be a good idea. But yeah, he's not that difficult. You know, just make sure you have the best food you can get, and which in this case would be a deer. It would be deer meat, and it would be boar meat and honey. Let's make a bronze. You ready for it to unlock? Watch this. Watch how much shit unlocks. 4, 8, 12, and 13 and 14. 14 items unlock with bronze. There's our first bronze. Our first bronze ingot. Yeah. I'm just gonna put all this shit away for now because I don't care. So we're gonna go. I'm going to show you how much fun copper mining is. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to change out the bow for a pickaxe. Right? We're going to put that all the way down. Okay. This is how I would suggest doing it at first. Is one, get a camp, set up a camp with a smelter and a forge really close to it. I personally have the portals turned off. Yeah, so I can take metal through portals because I find that whole thing to be obnoxious. But what I'll... Hang on a second. Thought I heard him crying, but I didn't. But yeah, he's not went for lunch early. No big deal. It's pretty close to the start of the stream. So if you rewind, you can see it. But he's really easy. If you want a server up, let me know. I'll join you. I'm more of a solo player, but thank you very much for the invite. All right, let's go do this. Now, let me show you this. Okay? Let me show you the joys of copper, okay? Hang on, I hear him crying. Hold on, guys. Sorry, I'll be right back. Sorry about that, y'all. I'm not used to his noises because he doesn't really make many. So when he starts making noise. I'm like, okay, what do you want? I don't know. I have no idea what this means. Okay. So here we are at our copper vein, right? We saw this thing before. This is the closest one I've got to where I'm at. Yeah? Okay. So here's the copper vein, right? The first thing I want to do is I want to clear this thing out to see how big it is underneath. Yeah? I need to see how large it is. Yeah? Damn it. Now my ear itches. Oh. Okay. So what I do, the first thing I do, is I turn off auto pickup. If you look here, it says toggle auto pickups in the middle left. Basically, you hold the left bumper, yeah, the block button, and then press the left stick. It turns auto pickup on and off. I turn auto pickup off, okay? I don't need it right now. Oh, now it's going to be fucking misty. Well, that's fine, whatever, it doesn't matter. So what we need to do is we start digging. The reason I turn off auto pickup is because this generates a lot of stone. Yeah. We start digging. Just start chopping the stone straight down. The only unfortunate part about this is that the hitting the ground doesn't give you any skill. It's only hitting rocks and deposits where it gives you. Olaf's good luck. Yeah, it's but you will at some point hit the bedrock, which we are here. See, we're not digging down any further. This is how deep this fucking copper vein goes down, guys. Okay? No shit. This is how deep it is. Now the next thing I gotta do is cut a trench to get out. How I do this is I line it up. If you look up on the top right, you can barely see it. I line it up so I'm pointing either directly north, directly east, directly south, or directly west. If you line yourselves up on the cardinal points, when you cut, the shear points will be a lot more manageable. Yeah. We're gonna do. Yeah, get the axe out, chop this out of the way. Okay, cut that out of the way. Go back to this. Okay. Get rid of the trash, because again, anytime you excavate, it makes a shitload of noise. Yeah. So you face directly east, which is this way. We chop one, two, move forward. We can't move up, so we chop one more. We move forward. One, two, three. And one, two, three. Now we get the axe out, chop this fucking thing down. Time to dig a moat. That's basically what you do, yeah. What I'm doing right now, what I gotta do first, is I gotta cut everything out of the way. Right? I have to get myself a way out of this trench. But at the higher levels, yeah, at the higher levels, I generally don't have to worry about it because my jump is so high that I can just jump. But see right here, right? I'm trapped. I got this fucking log here, and I can't get out. So we're gonna try and jump here. See, his jump ain't high enough. So now I wait for my stamina to come back. There we go. I gotta get this fucking thing out of the way. Look, are you fucking kidding me with this shit? Fine. Come on, man. Now I'm in a bad mood, dude. Yeah, whatever. Eat a fucking dick. Alright, now we gotta chop this out of the way. Right? We gotta get this motherfucker out of the way. And we probably have to get this motherfucker out of the way. So let's get that out of the way. And we probably have to get this one out of the way, so let's get this one out of the way. But right now I just need to dig a trench so I can get out of this moat. Yeah? Okay, come on. Let's cut the stump. And we'll get this out of the way, because these will fall in the hole, right? But if wood falls in the hole, I don't care. Okay, back to what we were doing. But see how nice and even the lane is? There's not a lot of jaggedness on the sides. That comes from going directly east, directly north, directly south, directly west. Three. Now the difficulty, well, okay, so the downside here, right? Is you're like, okay, cool, I can make a trench and get out. Well, this also means that enemies can get in. So keep that in mind, that if you're down there digging, you hear grumbling, they're going to come running. But you see here, Oh, it knocked down a birch tree. So if you look, right, it's a direct run right to my fucking camp. So, cool. All right, so we got that done, right? Now what we do, it starts raining. Of course it does. Why wouldn't it? But now what we do is we sit down here at the bottom of the trench, and we carve all the way around this motherfucker. Yeah? Sit down here and just carve stone. Going for the bottom of this thing, yeah? Making ourselves a trench. The nice thing about the trench is, if your jump is high enough, once you've created a moat, yeah, around this thing, the enemies can't attack you when you're on top of it. So what you do is you make a narrow moat and you just jump across the gap on top of the ore, and get it rolling that way. Okay. But this takes a long time, yeah? Because I'm just... Oh, shit. Auto pickup was on. This is why I turn auto pickup off, right? Because I don't want to be slowed down. I don't care about the stone. I'm not mining the copper. I don't give a shit. What I need to do is create a gigantic trench here to go all the way down as far as possible until I stop falling when I hit the ground. The ground is not level. It's not stable. It will vary in height. Then you get shit like this, right? I got a big ass fucking stone right next to the copper vein. The copper deposit's right here. Thankfully, in this game, the laws of physics don't generally apply. Which means, if I carve through this stone and carve the bottom out of it, it generally won't fall down. I can carve a tunnel through the bottom of it, yeah? But it's stone, and it takes a long fucking time. The problem with the stone, of course, is that the enemies will use it as a bridge to the copper. So at some point, I'm going to have to carve this whole fucking thing up. Yeah. But yeah, you get the idea, right? So let's go back the other way. Yeah. Let's start carving this way. I'll do the stone off stream because I'll be there probably for a good 45 minutes to an hour doing nothing but this. Hammering the fucking pickaxe button and carving shit up. Yeah. Let's see, I got some play up there. So move around here. If you're playing this game long term, you want to save the stone that you're getting, yeah? Because you're gonna need it when you get to the Iron Age. You're gonna need more stone than you possibly imagine if you want to start building castles. Yeah. But this is what you do, right? You trench the whole fucking thing. This will take, I don't know, depending on the size of the deposit. The nice thing is hitting at the bottom takes huge chunks off the top, right? So you're like, okay, that's fine. But then you gotta cut down any trees that fall in, and you gotta cut down any stones, and you gotta cut down anything else just to get to the goddamn copper in the first place. Then you'll spend the next 7 to 10 game days, which is anywhere between 3.5 and 5 hours, carving copper, running it back to your base, carving copper, running it back to your base. And then you'll get, well, depending on the size of the deposit, if it's a big deposit, you'll get, I don't know, Valheim players can correct me if I'm wrong, but I generally see anywhere between 90 to 120 copper, which comes down to 45 to 60 bronze, provided you have 45 to 60 tin as well, and you got to go out, you know, farm that. But tin's easy. We saw how easy that was. You just run around and just do it real quick. Then you put it on the smelter, wait for it to all smelt, right? I mean, obviously, you're not going to sit there and just watch the thing smelt. What you do is when you run a load back, is you just stick tin in there. Yeah? Does the little cart help running back? The little cart does if you've got portals turned off. Generally, what I will do is I will just run back and forth. I don't really mind. I will carry back, you know, however many I've got at a time. But it's a lengthy process no matter what you do. And, but yeah, in fairness, just to let you know, I can take metal through portals. I turn that shit off. I find the conceit ridiculous. If, however, you do not have that turned off, if you're playing vanilla, okay, you will be only able to carry 30 to 35, maybe 40 ore at a time. And that's once you get the bell. If you build a cart, you can put a whole lot of ore in there and haul it back to your base that way. The cart is a rickety pain in the ass. And I've never done it, so I would recommend watching a better player's video to see how to work it. I've tried it once, and I broke the cart like 6 times trying to get it back. I mean, there's people talk about, yeah, we build roads and shit. I'm like, yeah, I ain't got the patience for that shit. This is a casual game, dude. I'm not doing that. I ain't doing that. So, I generally run them back and forth between portals and bases and shit like that. I'll build a quick little base with a portal and a bed in it, and just take the stuff back that way. I mean, this takes long enough as it is. I don't need to add more length to it because of arbitrary game mechanics. Oh, good. There's another stone here. Okay. We're going to carve around that guy for now, I think. Let's carve around him for now. Just to give you an idea where... Oh, another stone. Good. Have to get rid of that one, too. Nice. Yeah, I can't get through here. Okay, well, we're going to have to get rid of this one. But the little cart does help running back when you're playing vanilla. Yeah, you're playing the original way. It's almost a requirement, I would say. But that's why I turn portals off, because the whole thing doesn't make sense to me. It's like, well, you can't take metal through a portal at all, really? So I make bronze armor, I make bronze weapons, I can't go through a portal? Oh, you can. Well, wait. Either it can take metal or it can't. It's like, oh, well, it's because you've refined it and processed it. But you can't take ingots through either, dude, so I don't know what you're talking about. Okay, more stone here, so now we go around. Watch for falling rocks. More like falling trees. The trees will kill me. This copper thing is going to take me the better part of, I'm going to say, anywhere between 6 and 8 hours to completely excavate this thing. Yeah. And then, but on the bright side, I'll only have to do it maybe 8 or 9 times, 6 or 7 times to get my gear. Yeah. To get my gear, to get my upgrades, to get my nails, to get the forge upgrades, right? But the bright side is this only lasts you through the Black Forest, because once you get through the Black Forest, you go into the swamp, and then you go into the swamp caves, and, well, do the same thing again. Except this time you have to go into swamp crypts and use the swamp key to go into the crypts and get the muddy slop and get the iron out of there, yeah? And, you know, the swamp is much more hazardous than the Black Forest, so you'll be doing that a lot longer. And if you don't use portals, you're definitely going to need to use roads, because there's no way you're dragging a cart through the swamp without roads. Meanwhile, abominations and fucking draugr are attacking you every which way. Haven't been to the mountains yet, but I think silver is the metal there that you got to use. And, but yeah, this is just the start of the grind, yeah? This is why most people will play the game through the meadows, kill the boss. They'll do the Black Forest, do the copper run, kill the boss. Get to the swamp, figure out how much fucking grinding they gotta do, and they just shelve it. They're like, I ain't doing this. I'm just not gonna do this. I'm not gonna do the same grind over and over and over. Now, if you approach it as more of a meditative exercise rather than a speed run kind of thing, it's kind of nice to be able to just log in for half an hour and make a little progress, right? I chopped a little more ore, I smelted a little more ore, I smelted a little more ingots. I got my way through another fucking whatever the fuck, yeah? But this is tedious as shit. You just have to, it's just something has to be done. Because while there are players that could probably take on the swamp with bronze, I mean, they could probably take on the shit with Stone Age gear, it ain't me. And, but yeah, I mean, like, you have a hard day at work, you've been doing all kinds of shit, and you use your brain or whatever the fuck. You come home, you have a drink, you have dinner, and you're like, I'm just going to sit here and smash rocks for 3 hours. Like, kind of relaxing. Yeah. And you're making progress, right? Every time you do this, you're making a little more progress. Right? Towards your goal of getting the good gear. And, you know, you can always take a break from it and just go out and explore more and build a boat, go across the water a little bit, try a new biome, and see if there's anything you can find out there or whatever. Because if you can survive the Black Forest with my wind down before bed, yeah, I mean, this certainly doesn't require a lot of thought, yeah? But you can see why I'm not picking things up, right? Because this generates a lot of rock. Yeah, it generates a lot of rock. Going down, down. Still going down. Okay, now there's the bottom. Okay. So now we turn around and go back this way to make sure there's no ramp I can't get out. But this is why this game is not as popular as it could be. Thankfully, there is something called a hammer mode, which is a free build mode. I don't know if that applies to crafting or not, but I would imagine one of the server settings is that you can make crafting not cost anything. And if you can, you can skip this whole fucking part completely. Just craft the items you want and be done with it. But this is part of the journey, right? But this is why people, I got a feeling between the increased difficulty of the swamp, right? Because going from the meadows to the Black Forest, it's a little bit of a jump, right? But going from the fucking Black Meadows, from the Black Forest to the swamp, yeah, it is no joke. It is severe. Oh, it's a blueberry. I guess I'll take that. Where's the blueberry? I'll pick that up. Okay. So this is why I'm not picking anything up. This is why I brought all 6 pickaxes. Because you're gonna be doing this for a fucking while. I mean, he's been a little bit working on this since the crack of dawn, right? All day long we've been doing this. But as noted, it's therapeutic. It can be relaxing. Let's go through here. Okay, where's the ore? Is it there? No, that's a rock. I'm chopping around the rock. Because the copper... Jesus fucking Christ. How far are we going here? Oh, we chopped under their thing there, didn't we? Okay, so this, I didn't have to go nearly this far. Okay, let's see what we got. Okay, so see, they can find their way into the trench. Okay, so I don't know where the hell I was going, but I was starting to wonder why this thing was so fucking big. Now I gotta find my ramp. Okay, here's my ramp. Here we go. Here's my ramp. Okay, so what the fuck was I carving under? Oh. Well, now I can't see a fucking thing anyway. Let's get out of here. So now what we do, we turn auto pickup on and we pick up as much shit as we can on the way back. Just to clean this up a little bit, give us some materials, and make it not a complete waste of fucking time. Yeah. We'll go ahead and sleep, and we'll come out here tomorrow, and we'll see what we got to work with here. But I was not expecting this to go around the back of a rock. That was not cool at all. Okay, so we're done there. Good. All right. Let's go back. On this trench of doom. I gotta find out where the edge of this copper node is, man, because it's clearly not where I thought it was. Okay. Oh, is that a seed I can pick up? No, it's just wood. Okay. All right. So there was one day. Yeah. Normally been attacked by several trolls. Well, I've got the combat down on very easy, so that probably has something to do with it. But if they show up, I could kick their ass. I mean, I kind of want them to show up, to be honest with you. Okay, let's put all this shit away, right? Put all our crap away. No. Wood. Wood goes in here. And then stone goes in there. That goes in there. Resin goes in here. Eyes go in there. Blueberry goes there, and then the seed goes here. Right. Now we fix all our pickaxes. So we broke four of them outright. The fifth one is half health, and we have a full one. Fix them all. Yeah, fix them all. Put all this shit away. Come back here, cycle it, and do it again. Yeah. Always keep your shit working. Now I'm kind of curious how far that fucking thing goes down. So we're going to go sleep. Are you fucking kidding me? There are enemies nearby. Who cares, dude? I got a fucking fort. Where is he at? Come on. Where are their enemies? Yeah. This little piece of shit means I can't sleep. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Damn you, asshole. Okay, can I fucking go to sleep now? Please. Thank you. Piece of shit. Alright, fix that. Okay, and sleep. Alright. So do that. Comfort's up. We got plenty of food left. Day 27. Alright, let's go back out of here and see what we got, what we're working with here. Okay. So now, once the sun comes up, we'll be able to see what we're dealing with here. I think I have to... Yeah, what the... Jesus Christ, where the fuck was I even going, dude? Look at this shit. Yeah, we're not even anywhere near the copper node here. So I have to chop through that rock, because that rock right here is the end of the thing. All right. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's start chopping down here. Getting out that. Okay, there's stone right there. Trying to figure out where the fuck the copper deposit is. I'll bet you it's buried in the stone. This is not a good one, man. But it's close, so we're going to be using it. We're going to clear this off and see what we're dealing with. Yeah, look at this. There's just regular rock here and copper right here. Okay, this is a fucked up one. I've never seen one like this. Yeah, let's get rid of the dirt on this thing, yeah? Let's see, where are we going? It's right here, right? Recreate Mines of Moria, right? I mean, it's just, that's what you gotta do, right? Because you have to see what you're working with the copper. Because if you start digging down, you're gonna miss a lot of it, right? Because a lot of it is in little bits and pieces in the middle of the dirt underneath the ground. So what you do, right, is you carve a trench around it, see how big it is on the outside, right? Then what I do is I jump on the top of it, and start smashing the copper down. What'll happen is the copper itself, the actual copper material, it's like a thin layer, a thin to thick layer over dirt. There'll be dirt in the middle of it. So if you don't want to drown in stone, what I recommend you do is bring a hoe. Yeah? Bring a hoe, dig down that first layer, get that first layer of dirt exposed, right? And then flatten it. Just flatten it. Because when you flatten it, you don't get stone. It just goes away. That lets you know where to go next to, that lets you know where you can go next to, this copper node is underneath this fucking building. This is, let her deal with the dirt. There you go. Now you're cooking with gas, yeah? But yeah, this, it's a whole process, right? To make sure that you can maximize your time, yeah, and your effort and your energy and your whatever. Now I'm wondering, goodness, excuse me. I'm wondering if this building is going to fall apart. It's gonna collapse, isn't it, guys? Because it's not gonna have any support once I take this dirt out from underneath it. The problem is I'm hitting the fucking stone above me, and this shit takes a lot of damage, man. But I got 6 pickaxes, so okay. Come on. I just want to hit this fucking dirt part. It literally won't let me hit the dirt part. That's fine. Okay, so this will be the last thing I'm doing on the stream, I guess, is trying to get this room done. No, it'll collapse. If it doesn't have any support, it'll collapse. The thing is, I'm not able to hit it because my pickaxe swing goes over my head. There we go. There we go. Come on, a little bit more, baby. A little bit more. Let me get down there. Come on down. Down. I want to go down. Down. There we go. Right there. God damn it. Let me out of here. I want to see this. God damn it. Okay. So the part that was attached here collapsed. The whole front of the building collapsed. Okay. Fuck this. I got to know. Let's do the rest of it. Yeah, let's dig down here. Right. Get low enough to where we're not hitting the goddamn building, right? Okay, there it goes. Look at that. Okay, it's coming down, babies. You guys want stone? Let's watch it come down. Do a little excavating. When it collapses, what happens, it just turns into free-falling stone. It doesn't, Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna finish the stream by fucking taking this building down, dude. Just by digging out everything from underneath it. Need materials, babies? Look at that shit. Last little nugget right here, baby. Da, da, da. It is kind of glorious watching this. Nice. So I guess we're not going to have a problem with stone for a while. Oh, man, that was fucking legendary. All right. So, okay. So here's the, here's your lesson for the day. Huh? Unsupported buildings will collapse. And pretty goddamn fast. That was pretty funny. I don't worry about Grador spawning there now, do I? Whee! Okay. So what we gotta do for the next, for after next time, what I'll probably end up doing is I'll probably be digging away at this during the week. I mean, I'll be playing Power World because it's kind of fun. But what we're gonna do over the week is I'm going to excavate this fucking copper. Yeah. I'm gonna see what we got going here, right? What we're gonna do is we're gonna get rid of the bridge so enemies can't, because enemies can't jump at all. They have no ability to jump. So differing elevations, they're just completely baffled by, yeah. To the point where they currently cannot path downstairs. But you can see that this copper vein, which we thought was smaller before, is fucking huge, man. I mean, look at that. It goes all the way down there, and it goes all the way down there, all the way around here, and then it comes down all the way around here, and then it's underneath there somewhere. The carving, the cut point's right here. This is where the other stone hits it. But that's how much copper you can do that. Trench picking to fly my X-Wing down. Yeah, I ain't doing all that. We're just gonna pick up some rocks here for now, I think. Yeah. Come on, you almost did it. Oh, he almost did it. Oh, I gotta E again, that's fine. Okay, let's get our stamina back. Cool. There we go. So we take the debris, take the stone. We're going to need that for building later, I'm sure. Stone times 22. Wow, I wonder what the hell that was. And there we go. So there he is. There we ended the street. That's what he's got to do next. That his next task is to basically carve this entire monstrosity. Monstrosity up. Oh, I also figured out too, Xbox players. If you want to turn off the UI, press and hold LB and then press the start button, the one on the right, and the HUD disappears. So you can take good screenshots, or if you want to play hardcore, you can do it this way too. You can toggle that shit. So with that, we're going to leave him here. Next week, we're going to see how much bronze he gets. Yeah? But that's the grind, folks. That's the grind. We spent, what, a half an hour, 45 minutes just digging this fucking trench, and now I've still got to do this thing, which is probably going to take me a good two, maybe an hour, hour and a half, I'm just hacking stone just to see the edge of this thing, and then I can start mining it. Yeah? Whee! So with that, he got pants. Yeah? I might hunt some trolls in the office too. We're going to see how it goes. With that, I want to thank y'all for stopping by, sharing your Sunday with me for the up to 3 hours and change that you did. If you did, if you managed to make it through the whole thing. if you had a good time today, I'd appreciate you clicking that like button. I please and thank you. Click that like button. Feed that YouTube algorithm. Get more cool people like Mindmental and NSX90 and all the new people to come in and say, hey, what the hell's going on with this crazy old dude who doesn't know how to play in here? If you're new to the channel and this is the first thing you're seeing, you like this kind of thing, click subscribe for more of this kind of thing. I stream something on Sunday starting at noon central, currently Valheim. Might be something else next week depending on what games update and or do things that might require a review. As always and as ever, I want to thank y'all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.